This is going to be very scuffed because I don't want to stream right now. But here we are. Boom. Mifos. Damn it, it didn't load. Oh shit, it's broken. Fuck. What? Minecraft 1.12.2. There we go. Now it works. It's so nice without the rain, though. I forgot this was here. Hello, little guy. How you doing? You can stay. We cleaned up all the webs because Halloween is over, but we left the pumpkins. Okay, I'm bored. Hop hop. Hop hop hop. How was everyone's day? Did I leave? Did I forget any webs over here, actually? I might have actually forgot to clean up some webs this way. Or are they just pumpkins? I think they're just pumpkins over here. Yeah, they're just pumpkins. Another thing I did, we've got grapes. Lots of grapes. Turn it into wine. The bridges are gone because I replaced them with just land because it makes a little more sense. The path kind of goes to Liondale, but it doesn't entirely make it there. I need to be able to see my audio on desktop. There we go. Yeah, Trivago got some tiny altercations. I have a stomach ache and I want to go to bed. Or draw. Or write. No, I want to draw. Hop hop, hop hop. You have a question? What is your question? Also, if I like ignore chat, it's nothing against you guys. I'm just not in a streaming mood, so I'm just vibing. Boop beep boop beep boop 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 beep boop boop. Do 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 do. There you go. That's how you find the Mythos Discord. Unless that link is for some reason broken. If it is, fuck, I don't know. I got pinged, being like, "Hey, there's a stream tonight," and I was like, "Oh, what?" And so now we're here. Do 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 do. So now, as punishment, I'm going to go bother people and annoy them to death. As I do best. I think I'm getting sick. It's not fun. I don't want to get sick. Good morning, Ravengard. Who's here? Anybody? There's boxes on the floor and signs everywhere. Hi. Why is there edict banners everywhere? What happened? Did they get attacked? These things pop up when portals come down. Is everyone okay over here? Where is anyone else, actually? I don't know. Hello, you know. How are you today? Good, good. Oh, fuck, where's my water? I know where to check. The library. They always hang out in the library. Do. Knock, knock. Yes, take 3 hours to eat a cookie. Hello? Okay. Not here. Where else? Why is it? I think it's locked. Oh no, it's not locked. Hello? Anybody down here? Off limits, okay. Hello? Anybody? Nope, just some fish people. Cool. Right. Boop. Boop, 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 boop. Why is this place? I mean, I know why it's a ghost town, but there's usually at least one living being here. Hello? Afternoon. I forgot. Okay, where would they be? Let's see. We can check Rex's house and we can check the chapel if I remember how to navigate. Do 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 do. This is the chapel. I went the wrong way for the house, I think. Hello? Unless you're hiding. You in the back room? Hello? Do, 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 do. Knock, knock. Knock, knock. Peekaboo. Oh my god. Hi. Sorry. You scared the shit out of me. I didn't realize you were staying here. I'll leave you be. Nobody home? They'll come back eventually. Hello, children. And Malachite. Actually, is Nora a child or is she just small? We're asking the real questions here. I sit. What's up, chat? Distract me while I wait for people, because I don't know what I'm doing. You are blind? How am I blind? What did I miss? Tell me what I missed. She has child energy? Yeah, she does have child energy. What's going on? I don't know. We're just sitting here waiting for anyone to show up. Do you know where anybody is? Is Morella home? Maybe I can ask her. Oh no, her bridge is broken. Oh, that's unfortunate. Oh, Bestia, hi! I'm going to the library. That's like our meeting spot. We can have a story time while we wait for literally anyone to show up. Oh, fuck. Hold on. Okay. Was these gardens before? Aw, man. You have farmlands. Hello. What stories do we want to read, chat? What are these? Are these just random books? Yeah, they're just random. Okay, all the books are upstairs. What is this? What are these? Oh, these are just books and quills for writers. We have Sun Civ, Occult, Various Magics, of course, the Aether. Jesus Christ. The one about the lizard? Didn't we get that in the. Oh no, it's in this one. Fiction and. It's. Hold on. There we go. Poisoned Lizard. This one. You remember this one, chat? Once upon a sunrise, there was a clever young traveler whose lifelong dream was to fly a full span of imperious skies. With the wind on his wings, he traveled from mountain to mountain in mere months. No, this is 15 pages. Yet he could never catch up on the rays of the sun before nightfall. Exhausted after a lengthy flight, he decided to rest at a nearby facility to escape the creatures of the night. However, he could not help but notice monumentous festivities within the facility as he entered. A large band of hunters was gathered together with a rather impressive display of meats and berries. A young traveler approached one of these hunters, folding his wings, asking, "Pray tell, good fellow, what might be the occasion of this feast be?" The hunter turned to him and grinned. "Aye, nothing but the finest winged treats for all of our winged friends. We managed to feed something rather hearty and lively for tonight's meal. The battle was hard won, and yet we managed. It was a hard one, and yet we managed to conquer a legendary lean lizard." I'm really bad at reading books. "It was a large and rather daunting lizard indeed." The traveler looked upon the feast in awe, and then he stated to the hunter, "My, that is quite the achievement. Might you tell the tale of how you conquered such a beast?" To which the hunter, I'm jumping back before in before but chat, I read book, I speak caveman because I can't speak. To which the hunter responded, "It fell rather quickly after we lured it from its lair, with the scent of an injured mount, which we have poisoned months ago to poisoned moments before to weaken it. And would you look now, the plan was a success." Traveler was impressed with ingenuity. What? Okay. Then he remained for this festivity. Still, he felt unnerved by the carcass of the large winged lizard that lay before him, so he did not partake. The next morning, he came down to find all of the hunters had died. Some weeks later, the traveler continued on his way, and then he came across a rather large estate, owned by an intelligent and pompous young woman, with quite the fortune of gems at her fingertips. Upon seeing her, the traveler fell madly in love with her and proceeded to the inner sanctum to wed her. However, upon approaching the throne, her rather cruel father encountered traveler and said, "My daughter will only wed a man clever enough to give her a riddle that she cannot solve in 3 days." You see, the young woman was madly clever and has lacked a mental dilemma for many decades. The only man she believed to be capable of satisfying her would be the one with the capacity to best her in her strongest suit, and if anyone were to fail at doing so, they would be executed. And so the traveler confidently stepped forward and said, to the woman, "My lady, I offer you this riddle. This riddle. If you cannot solve it in 3 days, I shall wed you. I am one that slew none, yet I slew many. What am I?" The woman accepted this challenge, and for many hours of the day toiled to discover what it might be. She would offer many answers, yet none were correct. Eventually, on the third day ended, and the woman came to him and begged him for an answer. He looked up upon her with a grin and said, "Why, my lady, I am the poisoned lizard." The end. Story time did not satisfy the time we needed. What is that? It's just paper. Up. Oh no, things are going wrong. I think I started stream too early. Anyway, how's it going, chat? Let's just do some out of character talking. Conversation starters. How has your weekends been? They better be good. If they weren't good, we're gonna have a problem. What is this? Oh, it's a cupcake. Wah! Sorry, I don't have the energy to do an actual wah. I don't know if you were here when I mentioned it, but I think I'm getting sick. What other magics are there? Blood ritual? Morphology? Again, what? Oh, I don't want to stretch! Stretching means moving, and moving means being uncomfortable, and being uncomfortable means I'm uncomfortable. I'm about to have a sleepover in the library. I'm about to fall asleep in the library, or just throw up in the library. Oh gosh. Welcome to the stream, guys, where we do absolutely nothing for 20 minutes. No sick. Sick bad. That's what I said, but then my stomach was like, nah, you can get sick. Hello. What is that emote? What other books do we have? Oops, what is this? Ah, Journey to Hell! That's a good one. God, the Aether. My goodness. Oh my goodness. We got so much shit from when we went up there. Leviticus, I remember them. I heard a door. Oh, hello. Hi. I guess I have to go to her. What?
Being a Marshy's
here?
Hi. Yeah, being a Marshy. She's upstairs. Hi. Almost.
You're beating her up?
Why? Why? Oh, why are we with no Brynn?
Guys, come on. Let's not beat Marshy.
She's scared.
Well, I don't know what other reason she would have come here unless to be a punching bag.
I got startled. Guys.
Why do you sound dead inside?
I think I'm sick.
Have some coffee. I'm
this sure. was important information that you had to walk all the way from Chewbacca to share with us. Is that you think you're sick?
I came to bother people, but no one existed.
Your throat, you know?
Did you guys all come from Vanguard?
Oh, Rex took your ice cream.
What? Yeah, it's not even flavored. What the fuck?
It's vanilla.
Well, you know,
it's not vanilla. I know what vanilla looks like. That's just ice cream. That's not vanilla.
It's ice cream.
Dude, okay. It's if like you go into any aisle right cream. Now and you search up ice cream, you'll see that there's like vanilla ice cream. What you're holding right now is ice cream. Alright, there's no flavoring in it.
It is a snow cone made out of creamer. Ice cream.
Then why isn't it in a cone?
Okay.
Because it melted.
As the person who was carrying... It's not melted. I'm a walking fridge, okay? It's not melted.
She is. Did you not remember the amulet, Bozo?
Oh, shit.
I literally keep a bunch of...
Like, you literally have a vial of water that you keep on your pocket that you've never used.
That's a plot point that we don't need to worry about.
Yeah, you're saving it for a really rainy day.
Gamer girl bath water.
Like an exceptionally rainy day.
Yeah, I'm never gonna use it.
It's like the really, and you only took that much, an entire like bathroom, and you got to bottle that much.
I have more at home. This is my emergency.
Man, they're stingy.
I can't even see you.
You know, like the moms that have the hand sanitizer. That's just like Marshy right
now. This is my hand sanitizer.
Yeah, that's okay. You know what? That's all right.
What do you do if someone kicks you in the leg and then it breaks?
It's made out of stainless steel, but it's clear.
So if I kick you right now.
Spot point cleared.
That was such a delay.
Yeah, I was waiting for Marcia to be like, ah! From it just kicking her in the hip. So you're here to just be annoying.
You have a new gauntlet.
So you're here to just be annoying?
Yes.
Okay, come with me.
Okay.
What?
Shh, just come with me. Just unfettered. Just come with me.
I was down here earlier and I saw that one.
You're right. Come on, Marcia.
Okay. Come.
I only saw the fish people.
Come on, Marshy.
This is gonna be awesome, okay?
The fish people?
Are we going
people?
To see the fish people?
No, don't go down that far.
No, we're not doing that.
Come on, Marshy.
Okay.
Come. We're gonna sacrifice you.
Cool.
You recognize this place?
No, I'm frozen. Oh, God!
Recognize this place? Okay, recognize this place? Recognize this place?
Yeah. Hold on. It's still frozen. There we go. Wait. I don't recognize this part of it, but the building aesthetic looks familiar. Okay, now I recognize it.
Turn left.
Okay. Why is everyone here?
Come on.
Is this why Ravengard was literally a ghost town? Even with the ghosts?
Already.
Come on.
What? Where's the floor? Oh, there's the floor.
wait, I'm gonna be more cautious about this.
Congratulations, Marshy. You're in the war effort.
Oh no.
You've been recruited.
Who's Dan? Daniel?
I'm cleaning up my mess that I was fucking around earlier. God damn it.
God fucking get rid of it!
I dig it! Oh, the slime? No, that's their mascot.
It's cute! It's cute!
It is actually really cute.
I will punt it.
No!
Think of the Rex. Think of the children of Silvervale. Would they want you to punt it?
If it would relieve my stress, I think they would.
You also have two other ones.
Three.
I can't do random kazoo and lore. You know, I don't give a shit.
Do it! Yay!
So you don't have any questions?
I have many, but I feel like you don't care enough to answer them.
No, you should ask them.
Okay, how Sky? Why Sky?
It was a cheerleading competition that Flux, Teal, and Rex won.
No, Lily's got this. Lily's so good at explaining things. You've got this.
That was a really great question, but it's not worth answering.
Okay.
Really? I don't want to always have to. I'm always like the designated explaining guy. Can you guys just like.
Okay, basically, Rex got help from Teal and Flux to lift this island up and then teleport it away.
Why?
Flux did the lifting with his giant muscles and his masculinity, I guess.
And winning a cheerleading competition.
Teleported it away. Yes, we even cheered him on like little cheerleaders. He really ate it up.
Okay.
Bitch went yeet.
He really did say yeet.
And Teal, like, it's like Teal, like, he'd been in stasis or some shit, I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Teal can do that?
Teal's kind of, yeah, but it drains him or something.
Oh my god.
Is that satisfactory? No frills?
Sure, any more questions?
No, that was the most concerning questions I've had. Oh, how did you get the portal?
Oh my god. Damn.
Oh, Lily's sometimes useful or something, I don't know. Any more questions? You're not gonna ask why it's here? You know why everyone's up here?
Oh yeah, I said why Sky. Yeah, why?
Complimentary edict.
Because like, what? Also, come yeah, on, I saw Lyla, a bunch of edict flags in what? Ravenguard.
Oh, what was
is
your
that,
question?
Is there a reason for that?
Yeah, so, Lyla, how about you just recap all of, you know, yesterday?
Oh, that's a lot.
Just give you
so
the TLDR.
Tabby disappeared. Yeah, Tabby disappeared. Right. We all got worried. We came down to Ravenguard to find out that she decided to go to Rex because she was having dreams that the All-Knower was watching her, and, you know, she thought maybe Rex could help. Turns out, dude's watching Rex, too.
Oh, okay, maybe I should explain then.
Man.
She showed up because we were both having the dream. She doesn't think I can help. She just thinks that if we can feel him watching us in our dreams, that means he's almost to the overworld. So Tabby thinks that now it's time to go on the offensive, or at least that's what she was saying, and then to further reinforce the fact that she thinks that Rowan's Pierce's plans are about to come into full fruition, the Edict did a very impromptu surprise raid on Ravenguard, in which they tried to take Lucia and then kill her.
Oh.
So now Lucia's in there, and she hates both us and the Edict now, so I have no idea what is going on in her mind. She does not want to talk to me at all. But, so we have that now, and we talked with a bunch of people, and now it's pretty much Dane that we need to head on counter operation against the Edict, go into a full-blown war.
Oh my god.
We need a base of operations. And so now we have this place. Teal says it has a strategic advantage. Having it be in the sky means that it's harder to attack.
Yeah.
And the landmass that it's on,
where is
it's
this?
Bounded by a complete ocean. There's only that singular peninsula
Ravenguard.
Towards Ravenguard.
We're near Ravenguard? How did I not
and
see
Vanguard.
This?
We're like in between them, practically.
Why, Cam?
Oh,
no.
Why were you hitting me? Why were
I'm
you hitting me? Because
you're in the way, moron.
I'm sorry. Ow! 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 Ow!
You reap what you sow.
Ow! Ow! Ow!
I found Ravenguard.
Why is it shooting you backwards?
Goodbye, cruel world.
You tried to?
Yeah, I was helping you.
Well, I'll meet you guys at Ravenguard.
Okay, bring him back, morons. Anyway, like I was explaining, Margie, stop trying to swim back.
This is the fastest
way.
She's
really trying to.
She's trying to get into the archives so that she can take the teleporter back up.
Aww.
Please, someone teleport her. Kat, I won't call you a bozo for 10 minutes if you teleport her.
Oh, done.
You can make Cam walk back, I don't care. Anyway.
I'm like, I'm almost back. I'll be up there in an hour.
Did you actually see me sweating?
Yes, I could see you from up here. Point is, moron. Apparently it's a defensible location, as I was saying before Cam rudely interrupted. There is a peninsula where this is the only landmass that they could possibly approach on. So, now we're going to try to gather people here, and we're currently in the process of recruitment. We're trying to see who all we know that could actually be able to fight with us or whatever. And now, congratulations, you're here too, Bozo.
Oh, it's like Vanguard, but all over again. We recruit everyone from all over the world, and meet
it's
here!
Like Vanguard, but instead of trying to fix a fuck up, we're trying to prevent one from happening.
Okay.
Yeah.
Any more questions? Speak now or forever hold your peace. I won't ever answer any ever again.
I will probably have questions that I will bug you with anyways. Why'd you get a gauntlet from?
A dread.
Right.
You want to feel it?
No.
God damn, you like scarred camp.
It packs a punch. Do you want to feel it?
I'm sore. I'm trying to do some stuff. And that hurt even more.
No.
Do you?
No.
Do you?
Morbid curiosity says yes. Oh, shit. Why did Rex want to trade with me?
Trade back, bitch. Come on.
Oh. I can't. There we go.
So, I got a skull bracelet.
Lily.
I have a donut.
Kidding, you can't have that.
What do you want?
Hey, would you like Kingslayer itself?
Walk in.
I have 18 Crimson Cult banners.
Come on, morons. Let's actually get to work now. Is that another ascension? What the fuck, River? What could you possibly want? What could you be granted? What is your desire?
My chat's just like, wait, why is Cam here?
Isn't River already mod? Or am I wrong?
Wait, your chat's asking me why I'm here?
Yeah.
Is River not already a mod? Hello? Question mark?
Well, you can see if they're a mod. There's like gonna be an icon next to their name if they are.
I'm a VIP. Now you're a mod, River.
Yeah, I was like hanging out with Swan Lyondell. Swan needed just needed a break, so I just came out here for a bit.
There's so many.
I gotta go back to help Swan later.
I don't want to go in that room. I feel like Lucia's gonna beat me up.
She might. She was very ready to throw hands.
Oh.
All right. So now let's actually progress. Now that Marshy is an alternate
partner. I have been waiting for you.
So you got
guys.
That? We're all on the same page, Marshy.
Hello.
I think
Hello.
Okay. So now we're going to pay a visit to the rest of Ravengard to make sure there's no one else. Make sure there's no one else that we missed, and then go to Vanguard and try to recruit people there as well.
Okay.
Slow, y'all.
You should have saw me at the bottom of the stairs staring at my hands.
I saw Blood Oath. I saw Sam. I saw Arian. I saw London. Who else was there? There was Jester Spirit.
James,
that's his name.
Are you recounting everyone we just saw?
Yeah, I'm so she knows she's trying to figure out who we should still talk to.
Oh, okay.
She's trying to be helpful. Don't back
her
for that.
Did we ever talk to Nyxis?
No,
we collapsed from exhaustion right in front of him, because the plot demanded
Let's go! Hunt him down!
I don't think that takes much time.
Man, what a fucking island. It's so imposing to see it on the horizon like that now. It's off in this direction. My render distance is good enough. It's over here. Come here. Come to the docks.
No, I'm on the docks.
It's over there where I'm looking and punching.
I can't see it.
Your render distance. What is my render distance? 32. That explains it.
Mine is 10. Or it might be less.
Jealous, envious slightly?
Yeah, it still doesn't show up even if I amp it up to.
Well, because mine's at 32, and I have it had it loaded in, and so I didn't deload it because it'll keep chunks rendered from 32 away.
I see it now.
And
now I gotta turn
32. I will turn it up higher, chat. Don't fucking tempt me. Anyway.
Oh god, my game is so lagging now.
And that chat is why I didn't see it because I physically could not see it even with a higher.
Riley has like a render distance of like 2.
Excuse me.
Look, Mythos is a nightmare when it comes to loading anything. So of course, our render distance.
Come on, let's look around.
Thank you,
Victus.
Victus.
Hey, the lights just all came on.
Tauber?
Ooh.
Hello.
Is that new? Has this always been a thing?
Yeah. What?
What?
I'm Victus.
It's always been a thing here.
Where are we going?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Hello.
It's really fun. I was like, let me find a vantage point to figure out where they went, and then it got mopped outside the front door.
Victus
stands before his mage tower, using his own magic to levitate the boxes and create scattered in front of his home. He sighs.
Crimson portals. Entirely primitive. Merely mortal attempts to grasp a true dark power.
He allows himself to rise into the air, floating just a couple of inches off the ground as he would carry the boxes away from his tower to dispose of them.
Hey, Victus.
Rex, how the fuck is your computer not exploding? I'm simply built uniquely.
How's it going?
He has a fresh baby computer.
He glances in your direction with a single raised eyebrow.
I see you've returned to Ravengard. Do not think I ought to notice your disappearance following that ridiculous portal attack earlier.
He narrows his eyes.
Do you enjoy making it a habit to leave me to clean up your messes, mortals?
Sorry. We had to go somewhere. It's important.
No, my computer isn't perfect,
here.
Though.
You can't
One of my
me.
Drives is, like, dying on me. I lost
no, blame
a VOD
it on Marshy.
Because of
Make
Shut
it
up. I lost a VOD because of it. So, like, the first stream I ever had of the Gaia arc is corrupted.
Is it your SSD?
Yeah, no, it's the big chunky one I used to store all my shit.
Damn.
Can we get some O7s in chat?
Does it have anything to do with the new floating structure to the southeast of Ravengard?
He slowly sets himself and the crates down on the ground once more, putting his hands behind his back.
I noticed that as well. It was rather difficult to ignore the spatial interference I sent to that direction, so naturally I investigated myself. May I ask, mortals, why there is suddenly a castle floating above the forests?
It's our new base of operations in the war.
It's okay, chat. When I get there, I'll steal Marshy's perspective.
Have you ever heard the song Castle in the Sky?
The one thing that we're gonna miss is... Yeah, I made that joke. The one thing that we're gonna miss is that was the first time I met London in that stream. So we now lose that first interaction where we played that card game together.
Aww. My chat gives really everyone's depressing. Hugs, including you, Peter. Also, I remember that one time where you went to download Valorant and it broke your computer.
This is why for like never hours
I was up till 7 a.m trying to fix it. No, it wasn't because I downloaded Valorant and then you know on my computer. I downloaded Valorant and it wouldn't work unless I fixed one setting on my computer, and then when I fixed that setting it broke my computer. So whoa,
developer blue screens my computer.
Shut up, god. Whoa. That word. I'm sorry, I went feral. If one more person talks over me when I try to read, I'm going to literally wrap my hands around necks and start kicking people from the skull. Whoa. Ah, that would. I recognize it from your world's text. Well, I wish you luck in your endeavors in this war, I suppose. However, he quickly would pause and look back at you all. Hang on a moment. War, as in, do you intend on declaring a war? From that castle? Near Ravengard? Chill, Omfi. The war won't be in Ravengard. We're just going to be working nearby. I shall never understand the baseless, violent urges of you vessels. Firstly, it seems that you would rather that you would battle against one another due to petty disputes. I could at the very least follow that train of thought. It was rather similar to my functionality as a primordial in the darkness of the void, but now you wage war against... What, exactly?
The Alacrim Edict, Victus. We're not as petty as you may think.
You're still very petty.
Bruh. And you're still old.
I am not even entirely aware of what that is, nor do I care. Sorry, I was pouring myself out more water if you heard that. He tosses his bangs out of his eyes with one hand. That's Victus pouring himself some tea. What is the point? Did they mildly inconvenience you as well, somehow?
I mean, they're trying to destroy the world and return it to darkness? A kind of a big deal?
Kind of a minor detail, actually. Maybe totally not, and totally an inconvenience. I'm sorry, Victus.
He's not phased.
I've seen Marshy make out with a fish.
What?
What?
Huh? I just win.
What?
Finally, an organization with a worthy cause. Always thought that rim was far too light. Look, Victus, this is serious. Your form's not going to survive in that darkness. You're not a proper primordial anymore. He narrows his eyes. Watch your tone. Well, I may have lost my original form. I'm still far more magically capable than any of you combined.
Protective?
Wily?
I'm protective.
Someone want to play rock, paper, scissors?
Yeah, actually, here.
Scissors, shoot. I choose rock.
Let's see how this goes. Let's all play rock, paper, scissors, all right?
That's why we could use your help in the war.
Oh.
He raises an eyebrow.
Is that why you approached me? To attempt to recruit me? And then I do hate to disappoint you, but I'm afraid I'll have to decline.
What?
Since I've lost my form and gained a piece of a light being soul, I have, as you know, been overwhelmed with new emotion. One such pesky emotion would be feelings of attachment.
He turns back to you all with a serious expression.
If you intend to go to war, then that implies you shall be leaving Ravengard to atone to vices without your overbearing presence. If that is indeed the case, then I believe I know exactly where I would like to remain, rather than fighting alongside you like any other mortal.
You want to stay and watch over Ravengard?
Someone must continue to keep an eye on the town. Additionally, should you be incorrect and the battle does return to my doorstep, I would like to be present to stop it personally.
He lowers his head.
As long as I may stand, I shall not allow Ravengard's destruction. I swear it.
Then I understand. Thanks, Omfi. Don't sweat it.
Thank you for the hug.
All right, chat, let's put rock, paper, scissors on. Go, say what your thing is, all right? Rock, paper, scissors, paper. Go. Paper. Rock.
Kill me.
I said chat, not you fucking morons.
I didn't say anything.
Shoot beans, rock, scissors. How are you guys losing?
I think beans win.
You could so easily beans cheat.
Beans wins.
How are you all losing?
I think beans win.
Beans wins.
Enough with that ridiculous nickname. I may be ancient, but I resent the statement that I am an old man. I appear quite young in this form, thank you.
He huffs, his face turning red in absolute anger.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have a certain mess to clean up, you absolute mortal nuisances. Go and wage your war, but leave myself and this town out of your ridiculous endeavors.
We will. Thanks for looking after the place.
Cool.
Okay, now to locate some more people. There's not going to be anyone in that direction unless they're at church.
I didn't see anyone at church.
And did you just, like, try to talk to...
Sound like, Malachi to Nora! Shut the fuck up, Cam!
I forgot where I saw them. Wait, hold on. I saw them. There they are.
Marcy, we all found it together.
I went the other way.
With us.
You suck.
Your name fuck rhymes you with moron.
Fuck you.
Malachi and Nora stand with one another outside the ritual site behind Victus's tower. Malachi frowns.
This magic... I've never seen anything like it.
Look it! That box thingy is all floating! It's like a big crystal in the throne room!
I doubt they are in any way related. The magic causing this to float is far different from our true magic. Do not compare such majesty to something so... boorish.
It was so boorish, then why do you keep looking at it? Come on, look at me, Malachi!
I even find the boorish to be more enticing than you, Nora. You never should have followed me out of the twilight. How can I focus on studying this world if you are here to bother me?
Malachi, Nora, you guys really stuck around, huh?
It seems like Cam fucked this one up. They glanced over in your direction. In the sunlight, Malachi would almost be blinding with how his crystal skin and hair glitters and refracts color all around him. Nora beams, giving you all an aggressive and excited wave.
Hello!
Greetings. I see you've returned after the excitement earlier. I recall seeing His Majesty rushing around the abandoned village, entering combat against rather strange...
Why are we reading this?
...vortexes.
They were so pretty! I tried to walk into one, but some big red knight dude came out and burned him out, and I burned him half alive!
It was horrific.
Alright, Lily, say your line. Say the line.
Did you do a good job?
Yeah.
Yeah, amazing. Alright, guys, you know who to point and laugh at. Everyone point! Everyone point!
Oh.
I feel like Cam did this to herself. Before stream started, she announced multiple times to all of us in call, if any dialogue's messed up before a certain point, it was me.
That place was interesting. That's those weird place. They had a person that severed there. That was weird.
What?
One day.
Malachite. Okay. No, fucking...
Oh my god, okay. Those were crimson portals. You guys didn't get hurt, right?
On the contrary. Those who approached us seemed to fall rather quickly to our superior abilities. Whoever those strange intruders are, they clearly were unprepared to do battle against a high-ranking and crystalline such as myself. However, I must inquire, are such occurrences common in your world? Is this a threat you often must remain alert to counteract? Battling against strange knights for... what did you call them? The Crimson Portals?
Well, it's not supposed to be common, but... we have done it a lot, yeah.
Hydrate, thank you.
Hydrate...
Interesting. I may only assume it has something to do with your superior power in this realm.
Wait a second. I get it. They're trying to assassinate you again.
You feel Teal just sigh in your mind. Flux chuckles.
How does it those idiot friends of yours call this? A head in hands moment? Well, I would highly doubt such incompetent fighters would be the ones sent to complete an assassination contract. I do find myself considering the same reasoning as a possibility.
It's not that at all. Those knights are part of the Alacrim Edict.
Hit the gritty, Dan plan. What the fuck does that mean?
Daniel, hit the gritty!
Thank you for the hydrate.
I have never heard of this organization.
A la crumb? That's such a weird word. Came up with it.
Certainly the name alone seems rather malicious, however. I assume there's some opposing empire to your own?
I mean, that's kind of one way to put it.
Well, to consider empire to be...
Oh my god, I can't even read the chat that I was trying to read!
You put a cooldown timer!
Yeah,
have you not learned? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
You're like Smiley, swan.
Either you god. Raise the price or you put
raising
a cooldown.
Raising the price doesn't mean anything.
Don't raise the price, just put a timer.
God,
a timer is the one thing stopping my chat from accruing like 200,000 channel points and just flooding me.
Literally.
I just completed a ton of hydrates.
Oh my god.
Moron.
I see. Well, they do not appear rather strong in any regard. I merely assume you made quick work of them?
We're actually going to war with them. Starting right about now.
Yeah.
Thank you, Marshy. I don't know what I would have done without your backup.
Got you.
So reset messages chat. I totally missed them. I'm so sorry.
Can't scroll?
No, not at the moment.
Do you want me to go into your chat, Lily?
No, what? No.
I got you, fam. Tonight.
I am just brain dead.
Malachite falters. War.
Aren't wars those big battle thingies that happen between two places? I think Brackwell told me about some warring kingdoms once. Or was that a dream I had once?
War is no joking matter, Nora. My mother's position among the king's castle was to prepare council, was to prepare for war and assist the king in strategizing around an opposing force. Granted, I have never seen a war for myself. But I was always taught to take such declarations seriously.
Well, we want to recruit you to join our effort against the Edict.
Yeah, you gotta be more useful than Marsh.
Jesus! Hmm.
An op choice? I could hardly think of anyone more intelligent.
Does this mean I get to burn more people?
Probably.
Oh, can I go to war, Malachite? Please, please!
Why must I be your ward? You came here of your own volition! Either make your own decisions, or head to the toilet where you belong, Nora!
But I'm not about to leave you here all alone, admit it. You get super lonely without me.
I would revel in the peace and quiet, actually.
So... yup, freaking join, or what's the decision here?
I bet you if Dan had wings, he could fly.
Dan would fly really well.
Do you want me to leave? I won't leave.
Malachite looks over each and every one of you.
Somebody!
If you recall, I agreed to return to your realm with you to learn all that I could regarding your strange individuals and your abilities. I believe it is only fitting that I may witness the full extent of your power on the battlefield. Besides, I recall in our singular violent encounter many centuries ago, you went easy on me, didn't you?
He narrows his eyes.
I would appreciate a more realistic illustration of your capabilities alongside my own this time.
Glad to have you guys on board, then.
Cool.
You know, again, I understand Candy's lack of intelligence, but we'll meet you guys at the floating castle that's over there. Just go into the archives and take the magic portal. I'm so fucking kidding, Candy. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Genius here. You ready for this? I don't know if this has ever been said before, but it just popped up in my chat. They have a theory.
A
game theory is British. Because
I saw that theory too.
Yeah. The Alacrim Edict spells out T, and T is British. Therefore, the Alacrim Edict is
never
British.
Trust British people.
I don't know if Caspian's still floating around.
I saw him in your house.
Why are you in my house?
I was looking for you, and he scared
you
me.
You went through my entire house.
I've broken into your house many times looking for you as well.
Man, why is everyone breaking into my house? Tabby broke into my house and then was like, pressed her nose against mine and watched me as I slept.
What the fuck? People breaking into my house lately, too.
Caspian would remain in your home, polishing the armor within your bedroom. He smiles slightly.
Such tasks. They remind me of a time long before my demise. Polishing the crystal fixtures within His Majesty's room. The ornate armor of Alduin's neighboring chambers. Such intricate detailed and stop eating, cleaning, and service was the purpose of my existence. You okay, Caspian?
The brain is hissing at me.
Thank you for the head pat, Flynn. And you should have a strawberry warhead.
Strawberry.
Wallberry.
Well,
approaching 400k channel points in Lily's chat.
Oh my god, Lily, royal mess KZ,
thank you for following. He glances back at you all.
Ah, good day to you, Master Rex. I see you brought guests. A pleasure to have you here.
He brings a hand to his heart, bowing before you all.
I wholeheartedly appreciate your concern, but I assure you that I'm quite all right. I was merely reminiscing in the past. Now then, I have prepared your bed for you, Master Rex, and I additionally have ensured that your studies was cleaned, and the books were returned to their shelves. Each shelf has also been organized alphabetically. Thanks, Caspian, but I wanted to tell you something.
Oh, thank you, Royal Master Casey, for the follow.
Oh, thank you, Royal, for the follow, and thank you, Haruko, for the follow as well.
What does the don't do that redeem do? It basically, you put in a thing, and I'm not allowed to do it for a certain amount of time.
So if you put down breathe, Marcia can't breathe.
Eat him well,
yeah,
Kirk?
Sure, but I'll
what did I just
that.
Read?
Wait,
eat him alacric.
That's so bad.
No.
Of course, sir. What about you wish to tell me?
He rises once more, standing before you very respectfully.
I probably won't be home for a bit. I have to do work elsewhere.
He raises an eyebrow.
Work elsewhere? Might I ask, what would this work entail? If you wish, I may accompany you and ensure that your files are well organized and that you are made a hearty meal while you tend to your own business.
He holds up his hands.
The gloves that you've crafted for me shortly after our arrival to this realm have been quite the help in completing the house chores. I must thank you for such a gift, sir. You want to come with me?
Also, fair warning for the don't do that redeem, it might be ignored during lore.
The Elacrim addict.
Oh, God. Thank you for the head pat.
I would often follow suit when King Cyrus was called to Outlying Kingdoms. I was the king's loyal butler, and I intend to ensure such loyalty is retained even in this ethereal form. Such service is the least I may do after I fail to protect His Majesty, and met my own demise in the process. I'll assist and serve you however I can to repent for this failure. We're going to war, Caspian.
I'm gonna miss Lunari saying, "Oh, Caspian!
Oh, Caspian!"
No, dear God. Fight or flight.
You should have watermelon. Also, thank you, Poison.
He pauses.
War, you say? That is rather serious, is it not? Haruko Karma, thank you for following.
He brings a hand to his chin.
I recall hearing of wars across the twilight between several different kingdoms. Personally, I still remember a time when our own Crystal Palace was threatened with war. But the council and the king quelled such insurrections from outside kingdoms quickly. King Cyrus even allowed such rebels to remain in our empire. And while they received consequences for their actions, they were treated fairly and as equals after fulfilling their sentencing.
So you have some experience working during war. Another thing, could you turn Marcy into a rug for me?
Indeed I can.
Indeed I what do. The fuck was that song?
Although that being said, such experience is still limited by my own hazy memory. But I would be more than willing to follow you into your battlefields and serve you, Master Rex, no matter what. In this ethereal form, I shall not fail my duty as a butler to you. If that's what you want, then you can come with us.
Damn, the server's really choosing violence today.
Rather, you can come with us only if you do the marshy rug thing like I talked about.
Marshy rug!
I thank you greatly for this opportunity, sir. I shall ensure your comfort despite these dire circumstances, as well as the comfort of your esteemed guests and soldiers. Thank you, Caspian.
Oh, thank you, Haruka Kamra, for the follow.
Okay.
It was worse than lemon. I'm so sorry, Ezri.
Lemon!
Lemon!
Thank you, Karma, and thank you, Royal, for the follows.
What does the Kachow thing do? I'm pretty sure I put descriptions in them, but it's basically I find a way to die in the game.
I know there's nothing on the other side.
I can help you with that.
Why did you try to smack your face into the painting?
Oh, shit. Because we can do arson since there's no rain.
You
failed. That was an art spell.
You are a fuck up. Yeah, I'll help you.
Thank you. I was going to do that, but it took me a bit to get my gauntlet on. Wispy! I don't know where I'm going to spawn.
Wispy.
Oh, there's a blood stain. Oh god, I'm in Kane's room.
Hang on, how the fuck are you there?
Because I haven't streamed since then.
Oh my god.
You slept in there?
No, someone set a spawn point. For the boss.
Oh, I was like, okay.
Under the boss room.
Oh, I thought they were talking about Kane's bedroom.
Yeah, I know.
Oh my god, why did you sleep in there?
Saw that bed and she went in.
Sleeping
time. Nothing as comfortable as it looks.
Oh boy.
No, it was actually made of cardboard.
Oh boy, kid.
It was actually made of solid stone.
Oh my god. Anyway. So now, that's Victus, Malachi, Nora, Caspian. That's pretty much everyone relevant in this town.
What about that one guy?
That.
Yeah, me too, Marshy.
You're right, Marshy.
That one guy.
You're right.
The one that we... I saw him over here.
Him?
Who?
There's a mystery man?
I'm pretty sure we've talked to anyone important and relevant.
By the bakery!
Bestia!
Oh, Bestia, I saw her too!
What do you mean by the bakery? Oh shit, Griffin's here.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Oh.
Griffin's here. Anyway, okay, no, Bestia, where's Bestia?
Oh, she's at Morella's house.
Well, then also.
Right the way we came!
Oh, she's still playing in the dirt?
Why is she playing in the dirt?
Well, she's probably in the dirt yesterday. I think she wanted Morella for something.
Ooh. Hello, Bestia.
Damn, this poor bridge.
I'm just shit.
I'll probably, because, I mean, once you learn the voice. Oh. Beastie would be circling Morella's damaged home, much like a lost animal. She would scuff her feet in the dirt awkwardly, looking around.
Dollface? Miss Morella? Beastie is... We are getting scared.
She transforms into a dog, beginning to sniff around in the dirt for any scents. I notice in her dog form that she would have a couple of scratches and missing chunks of fur. Did she get injured when all those portals from Elena appeared? Bestia. She immediately looks up at you and turns back into a human.
Rex, you're okay!
She jogs over to you, her robes mildly ripped and her hair dirty with twigs and leaves. She skids to a clumsy stop in front of you.
We cannot, I cannot find Dollface or Miss Morella! Sense in this area are confusing, I. They are just jumbled and strange. Do you know where they went?
They're fine, Bestia. They're safe. Don't question the broken English. I'm working on it.
It's fine. She's communicating.
Yeah, she's doing great.
Yeah. She's making sentences. That's good.
Yeah. Her entire expression lights up.
That is a relief. I were worried about them. I do not know what happened after Alienus portals appeared.
She shivers.
I saw her. Alienus? She was here too. She was in the house. I got scared of her, and so I hid. I are sorry that I failed you.
You're okay. I'm sure it was probably scary for you too, huh?
Hydrate. Oh, fuck.
I must protect this girl with my life.
Me too.
She's precious.
But now I know that they are safe, and you are safe.
She looks behind you at your companions.
But there are so many other people with you. Are you here for us? I mean, for I?
For I? You mean for me?
For me?
She froze her brow.
But Rex said that we are I. Are we I or me?
When you're talking about yourself like something is for you, it's for me.
Welcome to the grammar portion of Mythos SMP.
I'm sweating balls. Why is my house so hot? Fod
damn. Me too! No, like, it's so
I
hot.
Are very confused.
She puts her hands up to her face and squeezes her cheeks out, stretching her mouth as she would say,
me. That is not a real word, is it? Doctor never taught I that either.
Doctor didn't teach you a lot of things, Bestia.
Oof. Oh, well, it's 69 degrees here.
What?
Yeah, you are really good at making compliments, Poijin. They're always so sweet and make me smile.
Wah!
Away, away, away.
Got a wah redeem.
She nods slowly, bringing her hands back down.
I suppose I are not very smart. Are me?
We're getting further and further away.
I am sorry. Me are trying to understand. I want to understand.
She frowns.
I will do my best to learn more in the future.
We have plenty of time for that. We need your help, Bestia.
Imagine seeing the dialogue. Wow!
Don't worry, I are sorry as well.
Sorry.
Thank you for the bubble check, and Ovek.
Ovek!
And for the buff support dragon.
Did Ovek jump scare you?
No.
No. Even better.
Help?
Her eyes glitter.
You want I to help you more? I want to help more. Do you need me? Do you need I to lead you somewhere, Rex? Or to find you something? I can do all of that. I want you to be happy and smile.
She beams.
How do I help?
Join our war against the Edict.
I are not doing that.
Thank you for coming into my chat, Flint, for the bubble check-in and just saying beans.
I'm going to take there a rolling go, pin back. To Marshy's legs.
Wah!
Can I help?
Have you
what
ever
have
used
I missed?
A rolling
there
pin
was
once
a
in
giant
life?
Castle in the sky,
yeah, I
and
bake.
Now we're recruiting people to go to war.
You can bake and not use a rolling pin.
Yeah, but I have baked and used a rolling
she
pin.
She immediately goes pale.
Goodbye.
And she immediately, without any warning, starts to walk away.
Where are you going?
She glances back at you all.
I do not know about going to war. War means that Alienus will be there, and Ignis, and maybe Rowan, or Doctor. I do not want to fight them. They are all very scary. They will get mad at I, and they will try to make sure I are never human again. I like to be human. I do not want to go back into the wild. I do not want to get hunted.
Look, BC, if you don't want to, I'm not going to force you. That we could use your help.
Wah. Sorry, my chat, or specifically Ovex being a little shit.
She hesitantly looks up at Rex.
I do not think I are brave enough for war.
You are very brave, Bestia. Alright, look, you faced down Iris and Ignis, and then you still got away with Dollface. You saved her.
Protective.
Protect.
I don't think it's up for anyone.
Nope, it's up for me.
It's up for me.
Your eyes sparkle.
I did? If I fight in the war, will it make Rex happy?
Look, don't join to make me happy. Join to make yourself happy. She pauses, her eyes widening.
Make me happy? Rowan never told I to do that before. I do not know what would make me happy. What would make me happy? I want to protect Dollface and Rex. I want to see them smile again and be happy too. And I do not want to be in the edict anymore. They scare I. So I want to help make them go away.
And welcome aboard, Beastia.
Beanstia, that's what my chat says.
my chat is talking about beans as well. We're being beaned and corned.
Meanwhile, my chat is talking about how you sound like Snow White, Rex.
What? They also want to like shove a soccer ball down a magic carpet.
Snow White does whenever she like sings, she's like,
Yeah, it's like, ooh. Wait, no, that's like Tangled. Fuck, no, that's
what she did.
It did.
Like that?
Yeah, you're right.
She smiles, tilting her head. Also, if you're saying it sounds like Snow White, I'd take that as a compliment. That means I can pull off a chick very well.
I are glad to be on your team, Vessels.
She would turn into a bat and fly over to Rex. She would quickly nuzzle herself into his coat, squeaking at him in a way only he understands.
I will stay in here and go with you to war.
If that's what you want. Alright, now we've got Batstia with us.
Batstia.
Batstia.
Thank you for the stretch. And why are you posting corn in my chat?
Yeah, it's they got corn. I got corned.
You know what's kind of sad?
What?
The edict plucked her up as a wild animal. Pretty much.
That sucks.
Yeah, so the only name she has is Beastia.
Mm-hmm. We should give her a name.
We should let her choose a name.
Yeah, it's strange to name a full-grown woman now.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe
it just kind of sucks your name will always be connected as a rank to the edict. Okay, so that's everyone of significance, right?
You're awaiting two laws while I did them, so yep. You just missed them.
I'm pretty sure we talked to anyone that matters.
Cat?
Holy fucking, you can talk to animals too, as Rex and Disney
princess. Is Cat back at tour? Is Cat around here?
We don't need Cat.
No, we do need Cat.
Why do we need Cat? What? No, we do not need Cat.
Cat's very useful.
Cat is very likely to crash another ship, alright? You see that castle with her around? It'll probably fall again.
Cat has saved my ass so many times.
Yeah, Cat crashed a ship and nearly killed like maybe 10 people.
She's learning from my mistake. She was not in her right mind up there.
Yeah, okay. And I can trust her to stay that way?
We already know what had to do with Cat's past
couple months have been
Lily, it might have brought out what she already felt, alright? But I refuse to believe that her just being up there would magically instill this idea of her, you know, totally being willing to just fuck us over like that.
Well, if we need everyone, then we get everyone.
That's not necessary.
Cat!
Okay. But I prefer Kazuma. Come on. I would prefer neither, honestly.
What? She's probably not around. We're just wasting time. Time that we could spend going over to Vanguard.
We'll get to Vanguard soon. Just...
Cat, you here?
Where is her house? Does she even have a house?
Is this her house?
Have a house?
Yeah, she has a house. I just remember... Cat!
Oh.
Cat. Cat, what are you
get
doing?
Get a contingency jar, not a bad idea.
What are you doing, Cat?
No more jars.
Cat, what are you doing?
Wait, where are these morons?
I don't know.
Cat.
Assuming
I can tell you're very angry, but I cannot understand you.
Damn, where are you at?
Why did you throw focus? Out? Now I hear you.
You were just
not here.
No.
Okay. Why'd you pass me an advanced focus?
I don't know, because it's useless to me. So are all my other spells.
What are you trying to do?
Hmm?
Oh, Kat is glitching out.
Oh no, Kat.
One is
Oh no.
Maybe you're right. Maybe Kat. We don't need Kat.
Maybe we don't need Kat.
Fuck. Kat's, I think, having a midlife crisis or something, or a robotic mid-afterlife crisis.
What the hell?
Chilling spell.
Kat's saying, I think Kat's saying, like, they're useless.
And she's jumping out all of her spells.
Raise your spirits. Magma wings.
Keep hearing cats.
Give it a sec.
Is Kat having an internet crisis again?
Am I having an internet crisis again?
Maybe. Yes. Did you close out of your other shit?
Yes! All of it!
Okay, well, now you're audible.
You're coherent now. So, Amos, continue.
Alright, back from the top, back from scene one. Alright. In positions, hold, everyone ready?
Wait.
Reset props, come on.
Reset.
Prop crew ready.
Okay, me and Deb are already here.
Yeah. Positions, reset, alright. And scene one, take two, and action.
We do need Cat Rex.
What are you doing?
Making another useless spell, like all the rest of my useless spells.
You didn't help me just talk to me.
Sense of edge in your voice there, Kat.
Useless spells?
Yeah, okay. Okay.
Oh no.
Causing Kat to break.
Oh no. Kat, you poor.
I'm switching.
Why is she fucking up in a stream? I've never had a problem with Kat outside of the stream. Why is this happening now?
Yeah, Kat was fine earlier.
Kat's been fine for like.
Kat is so mad.
Not during streams. What's happening?
I mean, the spell works.
Oh my god. Oh my god! It's okay, Pat.
Don't worry, just give her a second. She's switching the bot spot.
Alright, so we gotta take it to from the top.
Wait, hang on, quick. Alright, reset. Everyone, reset.
Okay,
reset props.
Reset props.
Let's rewind. Fuck. Dan, on cue, we will run in and talk to Kat Peterson.
Shit, here's the chilling spell. There you go.
Oh my god.
I'm in the process of DDoS and Kat.
Stop! I'm so wet!
Aw, oh, Kat, I'm sorry.
Are you on a hotspot?
Not yet, hold on.
Has this been like a today issue? Has Kat just been logging out today?
No,
this is just, it just started. Like, all day she's been fine.
Oh my god,
my chat is crying.
It is unfortunately a right now issue.
my chat's crying.
A bot spot, no more Kittersons. Yes, no more Kittersons.
Kat the beloved.
I don't know, that chill spell looked really fucking cool.
I think I helped Kat with that one.
I mean, what spell?
Yeah, what spell?
We
haven't
seen them yet.
Oh my god.
What are you referring to, Dan?
I really hope this isn't the final arc of Mythos, because I'll cry.
Ow. Dan, do you want to play that game? Yeah, you want to play that game? Let's see.
Are we ready to continue?
Holy shit. Are you ready to continue? Kat, are you on your bot spot?
Dan's a little bit crispy right now.
It's okay.
Oh, I love these things.
I thought you were gonna talk about me being crispy. I was about to be very
Kat, you on your bot spot?
Kibber.
Kat's contemplating life.
It's okay, Pat.
Out of character. Pat, Kittersons. Pat.
You know, sobbing. It's not working.
Complimentary law sobbing. In the house for technical issues. Wah!
What?
Just join on your phone and just use data and talk on your phone with a phone mic. Start typing, place on a Kat NPC and just put in some dialogue.
Why is this flower box like dead?
The stress is
record
just
an entire audio file for us and then send it over to Discord.
Bro, I remember
we all just do a countdown, play the audio clip.
Put it off this entire scene for another maybe an hour later when you could be not like me.
Kat, do you want to do you want us to wait? Because they, you know, we could do this. We could do this.
Tell me, blue person, what would you like?
Let us know.
If you could even hear us anymore.
Kat.
Oh, Pat.
Why is there a chicken under
Lily,
here?
Lily, you're good at consoling people. Console Lily. All right, console Cat.
Okay, Lily, you're doing great.
Okay, Lily, console Cat.
Okay. Cat, you're doing great.
Hug chicken down here.
Hug why are you in the chicken hole?
Why is there a chicken hole?
Air hugs for Cat.
Air we hugs can come back if you want, Cat.
Yeah, you.
Is she even late. Present? Oh, she's hugging. No, she's not.
No, Cat, no. Cat is gone. Cat is gone. The call.
Damn, that's a lot of crystals.
Don't let Rex Cat. Insult you. Yeah, you can't do that kind of redeem because that requires Rex following it. But Rex is not the streamer on my chat, so.
And also, I would never respect. Yeah. You can't have an insult.
Not maybe let's check back
fucking dance
at
the
later.
Chicken's free. Also, we can't have a insult Rex because that would just end in that would be the exact same thing as the Marshy dying one.
Maybe we should come and check on Cat later whenever she's not having a mental crisis.
Yeah, it's okay, Cat. Just so the audience is aware and just so you're aware, I love you out of stream. Mwah. On the forehead.
Oh, she died! Aww. You just
she fucking died!
For the fucking kiss
I mean,
of death.
I'm pretty sure there are a lot of people that wish that would be the way they'd go. Anyway. Cool, so there's no one here. Let's move on. Rex wins in the
I'm
argument,
determined.
Just like always.
Oh my god.
I know Cat's running around.
Looks like Cat's not home. Let's go.
I am fooled again by Cat.
Pretty sure Cat.
Fuck, I need Cat for pasting. Alright, Cam, you're gone.
Well, guys, it looks like that's the end of my stream.
No.
You guys saw me coming. I'm joking.
It should have been me, Arky cries out in my chat. Well, let me just do jumping jacks while Candy figures something out.
Hi, Ovek, welcome. I see that you're new.
Now you get
Ovek.
4, 5,
6,
7, 8,
9,
10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15!
But seriously, can we show some love for Kat and Chad? Because, like, she's sweet. She's a sweetie.
If Mythos ever ends, it'd be really cool if they did something like Marvel What If. Oh, that would. Yeah, that, I know what you're talking about. The, like the Disney Plus show, right?
Do what? The What If?
It's this show on Disney Plus about the Marvel Universe with all these what-if scenarios.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Like these little one-offs, yeah.
I thought you were about to go down the direction and be like, if it ends, it'd be cool if they ended it with, like, a Vessels Assemble.
Captain America.
On to Vanguard.
Vanguard!
I always win these.
We win these.
I'm gonna put
a bunch again!
Of
the top.
Yeah,
I'm in the boat,
here.
Cam! Let's go!
Let's
go!
Oh, shit! I thought you just accidentally replaced him. I didn't know that was like a plot point.
We're going back!
I don't know!
Hi.
Is he relevant?
I think he is! Look, he's sitting
yes,
here!
He is.
I read the roadmap.
Road
I saw his name in it. That's why I kept saying, hey, let's talk to him!
I did not read it at all. I didn't read any part of it,
I did, and I just completely blanked on it.
I'm on
Crackhead energy. I've been winging it this whole time. I haven't read any single part of the roadmap at all. And I wrote it.
Griffin. Okay. I was able to get all the way in.
Griffin would be sitting in Brandy's bar, writing a letter of some kind. He'd seem rather focused on his work, his tongue mildly sticking out of his mouth. Brandy would float near him, looking over his shoulder.
What you doing again, Griffin?
Writing an important letter.
Want any booze with it?
Lily's tough girl voice is probably better here.
Okay, go for it.
Want any booze with it?
The usual, but not too much. I want to be kind of sober when I write this. It's going to my old boss, after all.
Any luck?
I totally love the Vessels Assembly.
I think I might have. I think I scare the man.
He gets scared easily.
Yeah, you're right. So there is a reaction.
He glances up at you all and quickly covers his letter with his arms. Jeez, don't sneak up on me, will ya? I swear you're just as bad as some of the ghosts around here, damn.
Why are you covering the letter? Got something to hide, Griffin?
Pardon me if I'd rather keep my correspondence with Rorik a little secretive. After all, even if you and the guy are buddy-buddy, he doesn't necessarily want to broadcast where he is. Especially not if the edict's getting bolder. He betrayed them too, remember? Right, so he's not in that big camp in the desert?
No.
Bahamas?
What?
Among Us?
That was not Sus? English.
Among Us!
Whatever Cam Among said was not English.
It said Bahamas. Who knows?
He likes to move around. He won't be in one place for too long, just in case his enemies try to find him. From what I hear, he has a good amount of enemies. And any bandit leader would, right? He chuckles. Brandy would float by you all and set a mug on Griffin's table for him to drink from. Yeah, sit tight, yeah? I'll get you in contact with him. So keep your arrows in their quiver, buns.
I hate him so much.
Man, I don't know, he seems cool.
He told you to keep your arrows in your quiver.
Damn. We'll shoot you.
Let's go! Go quickly before a massacre happens. Go, go, go!
I'm running.
Scatter!
Oh, where's the space buns?
Oh, now I can see it. Oh, I'm getting into better view of it.
You did start the space buns.
We really need to get rid of that ritual. Because you can see.
Was it Ren?
Like the beam that from itch. The castle.
Who's Ren?
Yes, right. My chat is going to Moose.
You're right.
She's this pirate queen that we must, like, for, like, or captain that we met, like, forever ago.
She was so overtly just mean to me, off the bat, and I've never gotten over it.
I don't think she was overtly nice to anyone.
Oh, wait,
she was overtly especially mean to me.
Was it that really cool big-ass pirate ship that we passed Vanguard, like, when we were going to get Tabby?
Yep.
Cool.
You know, she didn't take over Vanguard, but she failed because she's not that good of a pirate, I guess.
Which way is Vanguard?
I don't know. That was a really big ass pirate ship.
Yeah, well, it didn't take over Vanguard now, did it?
Oh my god. Relax.
It's been like months. Are you still sore?
No.
Oh my god.
Lily, we all know I'm shit at lying. That was bad. Even from my standpoint.
Be careful. She will shoot you.
Since when have I ever been a good liar, though? Remember when we were in the fucking Twilight, and every time we'd run into someone, and they'd be like, "Oh, you're the Gift of Hamel," and I'd be like, "Oh, yes."
There for a little bit.
Did that just?
Yeah, I was the best liar.
Yeah, I forgot. I remember reading that in Lily's character description. Bad at lying. Which is good. This is why they're friends, because then Lily just ditched me. Because in Rex's character description, it also says hates liars.
Oof.
And in Marshy's, it says big ass liar.
Oh, no.
Can I drive?
No.
Yeah.
See you, moron. I'm kidding.
Black Spike. Oh, give me
look at Marshy the bozo being stuck off the coast.
What happened to the last two boats I gave you?
Hey, thank you for lending me this boat.
Wait a minute.
Smart.
Not another boat.
And we are guaranteed to have our boat still.
My boat backpack is like getting smaller and smaller.
Perfect.
No, I never lose a boat, Lily. You're always the one.
Never mind, I lied. In fact, Cam.
Well, if Dita, we can grab some of my place. Hello.
My boat.
Holy shit, there's Ebony. Thank you, Lily.
Yeah. Oh my god, Ebony's free!
Yeah.
He's free, he locked himself in that tower.
Yeah, but he got flooded in, remember?
I guess.
No longer flooded!
Why are you out and about, Ebony?
Hello, tiny child.
Just tiny child.
And he's older than you, Marshy.
Oh my god.
He's older than all of us! Yeah, we got a running tally chat. Among Us.
Fucking, I don't think, Arky, if you're listening, I don't think you realize it, but in that fucking video, the really funny video you sent me earlier, if you look at Power's eyes whenever she starts crying, the pupils turning to twerking Among Us.
How much fun that Kenneth is still looking at the selfs in the store?
Have you never seen a nightmare before? Do not look her in the eyes if you value a life, soldier. Now, if you'll excuse me.
What are you doing to this?
What the hell is that thing? Oh god, yep. Gaia. The nightmare stands very still, watching over Ebony. She makes a low gurgling sound at the guard as she easily encounters Ebony. Lily, go, you got this.
What?
Oh. And I'm gonna guess the rest of the Indo are just on duty.
Yeah, they're
Lily, is this the gear that you fixed?
Yeah, that is the gear.
It's broken.
Just why you just ripped it out?
Put it back. We were here for 40 minutes just so that she could prove a point. Fast.
Oh my god.
Alright, let's keep looking around.
That was inherently spiteful.
We gotta look for the people.
You robbed my boats. And not then you ruined my work.
Not where Queen making me nearly cry in chat.
Uh-oh.
I found people!
Cool.
Found people. Found people.
Oh, hey.
Hello, friends.
Yeah, I know, that's why I sent it. Oh, okay, I didn't know if you ever noticed it. Because it took me, like, a lot of watch, and then I was like, wait a second.
Wait a minute.
Something's a little sussy baka here.
It's so funny. Holy shit, Senshi. Senshi, appear in stream sometime, asshole.
Senshi!
<She's... laughs>
Are you capable of healing magic as well, Cersei? I'm curious. I've heard of some mages who combine medical practice with magical activities.
It's fine. Senshi has a job right now.
I have something wholesome in my channel. Thank you. Okay.
Was it Queen?
Yeah, it was Queen.
Read Cersei or die.
I wouldn't say that.
Oh my god, we all
well, you were taking
up.
Too long, so.
I wouldn't say that. I'm hardly even a doctor. I simply did some medical training before I joined the Edict.
That's your canon voice because boss. Everyone else sucks.
I was trying. I know I read Cersei yesterday, so it's gonna read Cersei.
Then why'd it take you an hour?
Yeah, I was
because
about to
because Marshy started, then I started trying to.
Marshy started because you weren't speaking.
You weren't going.
Yeah, the first time I'll ever defend Marshy. Don't let it be the last, you fucking Muppet. I went back towards this way, towards the outcast, because there's a fucking wall of people this way, but let's check out the other directions first.
Yeah, it's not like, I've spotted a meme.
That's what you sound like.
Oh my god.
Mina.
Now I can't
talk to her. The dialogue, and now I can't. Fucking, did you get in immediately?
Homie is like Zoro and is hopelessly lost. Look in meeting, you'll find toaster oven vec. I gotta find toaster oven vec.
Wait, toaster oven vec? I got you.
Toaster oven vec.
In media.
Welcome back. I hope you're not expecting free handouts from my kitchen. I did roast some corn earlier, though, and you can take one per person, all right? No more and no less.
Corn.
By only one.
Queen, you're gonna be-
That's more than one!
Fucking clicking, bro!
What?
And like she goes one and Marcia goes corn and then steals like fucking half of the plate like a fucking mountain of corn. You're like the fucking meme where it's all like, I would like one tray of peas, please. Thank you.
No, my donuts!
You. Shut the
I
Coco.
I'm going to be smited.
Coco is clearing the table.
Ah, fuck.
Nebula.
It's Haven and Nebula.
Hey, what's
oh,
up?
Oh, they're still vibing.
Nebula and Haven would both be talking with one another casually at the table near the bar.
You're Nebula.
So how do you feel now, huh? I can't feel anything if you keep distracting me, Nebula. You've been focusing for so long. I thought you'd be a lot faster at emotion reading. And for an omnipotent being, I thought you'd be far less ignorant. Ouch. Harsh. I didn't expect to see you two together. Hydrate.
Oh.
Thank you.
What the fuck? Are you good, Rex?
I fell
in a hole.
I love breathing my water.
Corn! All hail corn.
They both look up at you as you approach. Nebula grins while Haven simply gives you a respectful nod. Hey! If it isn't my favorite immortal beings!
Hello again. It's been quite some time, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's been a hot minute. You guys getting along?
You could call it that. Nebula's the only celestial I've met besides Aesthyr. I've been asking her several questions on what her realm is like in an attempt to learn more about my soul. Haven pauses, staring at Rex for a moment. Rex, your aura is different. Has something changed with your souls?
Nebula leans over. I sense it too! It's almost like they're not trying to murder you anymore! Pretty much. Nebula.
Nebula.
Nub!
Nebula.
Thank you for the hydrate and the corn emoji.
Wait, I was joking. That's possible? Just let me think. You have your vessels figured out, you find new ways to surprise me. That's fine. Oh. That's fine, though. I like staying on my toes.
Did you manage to reach a similar compromise with your souls as I did with Esther? Yeah, something like that. But that's not why we're here. Bubula.
Bubula!
Thank you, Queen. No,
you're butchering her name right now. What is Bula Neb?
Bula Neb!
It's my new favorite.
Bibooba.
Big Booba Neb.
I was hoping you'd say that. Don't tell me! I want to guess!
Nebula, don't you think that's a bit unnecessary? They're all going to tell us why they're here without you guessing.
Unapproved, how will I know that? Did you follow them around like a stalker for 6 months in the ether? I didn't think so. Just give me a second.
Well, we're really just here to...
Does it have anything to do with the Alacrim Edict? Wait, no, that's too obvious. Not everything's about the Edict. Okay, hang on.
I mean, you're right. It is about the Edict.
Oh my god.
Right on the money, man.
Nebula and Beluska, Nebula,
I have a question. How's the Q&A going? That's what my chat's asking.
Well, her response is never posted?
I don't know.
I don't think she's responded
A certain
yet.
Someone has been fucking busy.
Oh my god.
Classy Candy. She pauses. Told you I knew the vessel's haven.
Congratulations.
He doesn't seem necessarily enthused.
We're going to war against the Edict.
Pause. I want to let that sink in.
What?
Shut up. I'm trying to let it sink in.
Okay. Taking a while.
Ooh, sounds festive! Can't wait to see those fireworks!
War against the Edict? He hesitates, because obviously the thing worked the second that Marcy decided to complain. I...
Oh.
Oh my god.
I hope you're here to tell me I can go back to Blood Oath Island before your war begins. Not interested in getting caught up in a war. Especially not with them. He puts a hand on his chest. I still remember when they tried to take Esther away from me in that giant machine. I'm not interested in reliving that experience as long as I'm still here in this world. Even there's no way back to the island. Rax, thank you so much for existing.
Your
thank
chat's
you.
Been so Very wholesome. Kind.
Rex, your chat has found a favorite fast time butcher of your names. Ah, I think I figured that one out when you guys, like, for 100 messages straight, just raked Dan's name through the mud.
How do you do it?
What? Dan of all names, too.
I think they did, like, Dan on Ball Bowls at one point.
Anyway, his eyes widen. But you promised that you would get me back there. Did you forget? My real family is still on that island. And it would be safer if they stay there. The Edict isn't in Terramos. How can you be so certain of that? The Edict is seemingly everywhere, so why wouldn't they be in Terramos too?
Because the Edict isn't concerned about Terramos Haven. Nebula crosses her arms. Well, in the past, they did have a certain grip over that country in an attempt at total world domination. But when that failed, they refocused their attempts back on Mythos. And only Mythos.
But you learned all of that when we were in the Aether? What? What the fuck?
Big brain dumb.
I Alright, let's see how this sounds.
Oh.
I learned a lot while I was stalking you, remember? I'm not a scholar for nothing. Then find a way to get me to Terramos. I'm not interested in your war or anything like that. I just want to exist as long as I can before I'm ready to give up my body to Esther. Well, we could use both of your help against the Edict. They plan on destroying the entire world completely.
And we don't plan on responding.
God damn it.
This is going to be the entire stream, by the way.
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
Are you going to go on the Twitter?
Like, I foresee that.
Haven hesitates. Total world destruction.
Oh, come on. I've only been in this world for like a year, and I'm really starting to like it, too.
Why do you need me? True celestial like Nebula, I can understand, but me? Look, Haven, you're a strong ally. And you have something to protect in this kind of battle.
I am Protag.
Tag.
Going to hang Mercy upside down by your toes.
By the toes!
Oh, not the toes!
If they destroy the world, then Quincy and me, sir, are as good as dead, too. That's what you're getting at, isn't it? The Edict. I felt from their members, from their very base of operation. The emotions I felt from their members, from the very base of operations. It was a cesspool of absolute conflict and anger. I don't know if I could handle fighting against such broken and unstable people. Hey, look, your power and your ability to read emotions could be invaluable to protect the world.
I think you mean Megatron.
Oh, Maggie. So many names.
I was gonna say, isn't that Megalovania from Silverville?
Haven looks up at each and every one of you for some time. You have to protect me if I'm doing this. I'm not planning on dying in your war. I just want to make sure that my family stays safe and that this world isn't plunged into chaos.
As good a reason as any, I guess. I don't need to tell you my answer, right, Vessels?
She grins, putting her hands on her hips.
I want as many opportunities as I can to learn more about your world. I can't do that if this world gets destroyed. I'm not ready to go back to the celestial realm quite yet. So, what the hell? I'm always ready for another adventure.
Well, we're glad to have you both on board, then.
Yeah, plus if she did go back to the celestial realm, wouldn't she be, like, tried for treason or something?
Oof. Yeah.
What the fuck did she do? What?
She was assigned to be a scholar to study us so that the rest of the Celestials could know who they're fighting. And then instead of studying us and, you know, reporting back, she instead studied us so heavily that she grew enamored with us and the way we behaved and everything that we did, and instead started fighting and rooting on our side as this mysterious benefactor.
Also, didn't she eat, six of them?
Yeah, she ate several Celestials as well.
What the fuck?
And, yep, okay, here we go.
Protect your ass!
Hey! Indo.
What's up?
Ooh.
Nebula.
No!
She heard it from the island.
No, London's with
us.
Oh, she
is? I didn't know that.
Keep track of your party, Marcy!
I wasn't in the fucking thing, bro!
Oh, wait, she wasn't. Still no excuse, you suck. Dawn would stand with Trent. Alright, pop quiz though, Marcy. Who else is with us right now?
Dan, the man with the plan.
No.
Cat joined the game!
Can I answer?
Yep.
Bestia.
Batstia, yes.
Oh, shit.
Dawn would stand up to... She's in my coat, see?
She is in her coat.
Dawn would stand with Trent and Anne, the conglomerate twins. She has her hands on her hips as she would speak.
And once you're back, I want a detailed report from our hosts regarding our priority orders. Is that understood?
Understood, Dawn. Sorry, that's not his fucking voice. Understood, Dawn. Trent smiles at her and gives her a single nod.
Dawn, do you have a minute?
She glances back towards you.
Ah, vessels. Hello. Did you have something you wish to discuss? I was simply about to send Anne and Trent, but... Trent back to the camp to make a report to Lieutenant Arhos regarding Vanguard's activities. Oh, actually, that's perfect. We need to contact Arhos, too.
Did you guys just call Kitterson's gibber means?
What?
I mean, that's creative.
Okay, I'm on my fucking phone. Am I just audible?
Yeah.
Yeah, but you did that a little halfway through.
I cannot. It's only Discord. I'm so mad.
Nah, your phone's working. You're fine.
Oh my goodness.
Oh.
Please don't be gaslighting me.
Oh. Are you gonna read your line?
No, okay, the thing that was tripping me up is I'm in the Trent dialogue, yeah, so I keep thinking that it's Trent saying these things and not... Yeah, okay. Oh, I would be more than happy to inform him of any updates you have regarding Edict or outside activities.
She turns to you, Hula, your armor clanking.
What might your message be?
We've declared war on the Edict. We want to recruit the conglomerate to ally with us. It was autocorrect. Autocorrect brought you from Kitterson's to gibber means.
There you go.
What?
I got it. RR redeemed. I wanted to get it out of the way.
Hey, expression shifts. You notice Anne and Trent behind her glancing at one another, and then back at you. Anne would grit her teeth.
Okay, Marcia, you or me?
I can't trust myself.
You declared war! Anne exclaims. There we go.
You idiots! You didn't think to tell Lieutenant before you did such a reckless thing?
Lieutenant. Calm yourself, Anne. I'm sure they had a good reason for doing so. Trent attempts to calm her.
Why would you declare war so suddenly? Did our host tell you to do this?
No, but if we don't do it now, then the world is doomed.
What are you talking about?
The All-Knower is in the process of ascending from the Void. And I don't think it's going to be too long now.
Oh. Fuck.
Cat kibber means. Cat gibber means.
Cat giblet.
Cat beans.
You just gotta ignite. The paladin's eyes widen. The All-Knower. He's already ascending! Trent exclaims.
How is he ascending that quickly? We didn't even know about any of this.
Anne asks you all, storming forward before Trent holds her back quickly. Anne, control yourself!
How do you know about this, Vessels?
Rex has been having dreams about being watched by him.
What?
I don't know, but that sounds really fucked.
I told you you had your chance to ask questions, Marshy.
Well, you never explained the dream thing, bro.
I think that was explained.
It was?
It was.
And it was touched on, but it wasn't explained.
Well, you did mention dreams, All-Knower, so.
Are you certain they're not simply nightmares?
Are your glasses on? He's coming. I know it.
I'm sorry.
Dude, I'm just making a joke. Relax.
Merry Christmas, Cat Studios. What the...
Damn it.
She turns to the twins.
Both of you, go to Harhos and inform him of this immediately.
Yes, Dawn. The Trent states immediately. The twins rush off, leaving you with Dawn. Dawn remains rather still.
Are you okay, Dawn?
Damn, that was fast, Ben. Proud of you. I'm conflicted. There is a reason why we have never officially declared war on the Edict. We knew that doing so would immediately plunge all of Mythos into a bloody conflict. And if we were not ready for it? Are we certain? Are you certain?
Don't.
Think of the idea, chat.
Are you certain you're prepared for this, Vessels?
It's now or never.
In this world,
like Lily's ability to read.
In this world, it's protag or get protagged. I'll thank you for the hydro tour.
I didn't understand right
this. In this world, it's different.
I knew that doing so would immediately plunge all of Mythos into a bloody conflict, and if we were not ready for it. If we were not ready for it, what? 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 Okay.
What?
Did the second top. Okay, never mind.
Dawn purses her lips slowly.
I see. The twins have gone to deliver the news to Arhos. I'm certain if he is to head a war, then he will certainly...
He won't head the operation. I will. Alongside Tabby.
Maybe don't mention Tabby right off the bat.
Oof.
I don't like lying!
You could have just not said it.
The last time I did it, it like ate me up inside until I just confessed.
No. Better rip off the band-aid, I mean.
I mean, yeah, it's ripped off.
Yeah, there's only so many band-aids you can rip off before you just
Dawn blinks in shock.
Tabby. As in Tabitha? The dread we've been battling all of this time to protect Vanguard? What are you trying to say? You'd allow her to help lead the war against the Edict?
She shakes her head.
I'm sorry. We will simply be unable to accept that. She's sane now, Dawn, we swear. She's okay now, we're pretty sure.
Oh, you're so reaffirming, Lily.
Mm-hmm.
Shut up!
Cat joined the game!
Cat!
She already joined the game, then left the game, and I think rejoined the game. Cat kidder diff.
Pretty sure is not certain. She already attempted to destroy your allies, Wolf and the other ex-ritualists. Have you forgotten about her unstable activities? Damaging the Mage Tower, endangering the people of Vanguard? She massages her fuck.
She massages her temples. It's not a big deal.
And to even consider the conglomerate answering to someone other than an official paladin, while we ally ourselves with you, vessels, I cannot be confident in your capabilities to leave our masses as our host does. We will fight alongside you, but under your will?
Look, I can talk about it with our host. We can work something out. Trust me.
I do, or I would like to, but...
She hesitates before just sighing.
Time will tell. I cannot confidently give you an answer on our allegiance with your declaration just yet. While we support your engagements against the Alacrim Edict, this will require further discussion. War is not something we take lightly. It is far more than that.
We understand. I guess we'll talk to Arhos itself if we have to.
I don't like lying. Me looks back at the Dark Witches. I see why you stopped.
Yeah.
Thank you for your understanding. Now then, I believe with this new information, I should follow the twins to make my own report.
Dawn pauses as she glances behind you all, a confused expression on her face. You all follow her gaze, turning around to see Iris standing near you all. Her head hanging. She walks up to Rex without a word and places another wooden cup in his hands. Where do you keep getting these?
What the fuck? Why? Why?
When did Iris?
Why cup?
I don't know where to find you.
What?
I am sorry, Rex. I'm afraid there are some quests you do not want the answer to. Are you stealing cups? Please don't ask! Iris pleads. Try again! Iris quickly rushes away in her heels, covering her face in utter embarrassment. Dawn would simply watch in utter confusion.
I do not understand what just transpired.
Yes, Abe, what the fuck?
Yeah, what the shit? When did Iris come up? What the fuck? She wasn't with us.
I didn't even know where we were.
Yeah, she just manifested. Just like, cup.
Okay, London's here. Batsia's here. What the fuck?
I was just like, been silently following us this entire time with the cup.
We're going, and then oh god. I will simply assume it is unimportant.
She straightens her hair to adjust her cape.
If you'll excuse me, I must be off to speak with Lieutenant Arhos. Take care, Dawn. We'll talk later.
Cop.
I'm a collected individual.
How many do you have now to your collection?
I'm testing. Am I back?
Yeah! Wait, bug.
You
bug,
would not
bug,
believe
bug,
what it fucking
one
was.
Second. I'm
bug.
Checking on Oz because he's all the way out here with Lenore.
Fair enough.
You got very on eyes, Oz.
I am curious what it was, though, Kat.
It was
I'm
my
afraid.
Fucking webcam.
Shut the fuck up. I'm afraid Miss Lenore is busy at the moment. Please come back later.
The web?
Damn it, they won't let us check on Lenore. Okay.
Squad.
I think we would... She would hate me even more if I brought
her my net. Welcome, Timber.
Bug.
No, are you guys ready for a conversation that only I can have?
Yeah,
yes.
I'm gonna pet Ozzy. Ozzy!
Nah, it's just gonna be like a series of like, I'm gonna guess barks, meows, and squawks for you guys.
Ozzy,
yeah, that's what it was when we were talking to them yesterday.
Oh, that's not my sit key. There it is. Hi. Pet.
Wanna say hi to you, Bug?
Pet.
Okay, bug. Scritches on the head. Scritches on the head for Bug.
Scratchy.
Pet.
Oh, it's the same
join
thing.
The animal squad?
What?
The large dog would stand rather still among the other animals. His eyes would remain narrow while Ozzy would simply meow and brag to the entire group. He huffs, allowing his entire body to drop to the ground, causing Harmony to flutter and Bug to chortle in alarm. Ozzy would jump even, his back arching. Atticus?
Pat.
Bat.
Dialogue hated. Please.
Are we allowed to go further in the dialogue?
Yeah, that's the thing. I don't know if we're allowed to.
No, I think it's fine if you guys are there to read it. It's just canonically you don't hear it.
Okay.
Pretend you're listening to me communicate with a bunch of animals as they bark, squawk, and meow.
Like Atticus, and then and you're like, oh, okay.
The large dog opens one eye, glancing back up at you.
No.
All right. I see you've come back, Jared. He adjusts his seated position on the wooded planks. It's been some time since you've come to the city. I've been busy.
Rec, hey Rec, stop that.
He rests his head in his paws. What are you doing here now, then? Further business in Vanguard?
You could say that. He growls at you.
I suggest, if that's the case, you complete your business quickly. Your company, as well as the company of these smaller creatures, tires me.
I'm gonna need your help, Atticus. How aggressive are you going to meow?
Meow.
It's Ozzy. Alright, I think you know the answer to that question.
Meow!
Yeah, for them it's Atticus.
Been busy. You could say that. He pauses. No. Look, it's about the edict. We're going to war. I want you to come with me.
He rises once more, licking his paw.
I'm no stranger to war. I've been in plenty of battles. But I do not go into battle with those I do not see as my equal. And you, Dread, you are not my equal.
He begins to walk away. Look, you'll get to fight again. Isn't that what you want?
Big dog.
Now, I don't understand why other people joined in on him barking.
Perhaps, but I'm willing to wait.
Don't worry about him, Rex, man. He's just a little coward. Even more than my folks back home.
Ozzy would tease. Atticus immediately pauses. His hair stands on end and turns towards Ozzy.
What was that? Cut?
Ozzy immediately squeaks.
I am a true warrior, kitten. You will learn to remember that. I do not stray away from battle. I choose my battles.
Yeah? Then prove it. How did they make a dog emote? Don't underestimate the power of mythos. He rises before all of you, lunging in your direction aggressively. He causes you to take a small step back.
You will regret questioning my abilities, Dread. I will not prove myself to you. I was bred for this. But you? You will prove to me why I should not question you. That is all.
Sounds like a deal to me.
What the fuck were you talking? That dog was growling the entire time.
Yeah, that dog pissed him off, dude.
Yeah, it's about yeah, pissed him off just of the...
a second away from getting my nose bitten off, but you know, it's just whatever.
So Voldemort.
Pat.
I'll just be bragging to the group of animals, laughing and meowing loudly. And after I freed Rexman from that trap in the jungle, obviously he decided to keep a fearsome warrior like me around. That's a lie, and you know it, Kat. You were the one stuck in the cage. Rexy told me all about it, and it was very embarrassing and funny. That is not true! I'm his greatest and most loyal vassal!
Ozzy, you're not telling people I was stuck in the cage, are you?
This feels like one of those classic moments when you're like talking mad shit and the person walks up behind you. They're right behind me, aren't they? Like, you know?
What do you mean, Lila? You can't hear anything.
It's an out of character comment, kid.
Meow! 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 Rexman! It's been a while, hasn't it? Me? Lying about you? No way! I would never! Like I said, I'm your greatest and most loyal vassal. That means I ain't no snitch or liar, you hear? Ha 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 ha. How embarrassing, huh, Rexy? Also, hello and welcome back. Did you miss me? Harmony would flutter up to your shoulder and pick at some feathers under her wing. Your beastie and your coat.
More intelligent animals? There's so many!
Mm-hmm. A beastie, there's Ozzy. It's my cat. And that's Harmony, my parrot. This chair!
This chair is killed.
Hang on, is that a bat in your coat? Aw, come on, Rex, man! You didn't replace me, did you? That's not cool!
Ha 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 ha, you got replaced by a bat, how embarrassing for you, but you would never replace me, right, Rexy? Because you love me so much, I'm the best, you don't have to tell me, but you should also... It's just... Fuck! God, Harmony! I'm gonna start from the beginning. Ha 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 ha, you got replaced by a bat, how embarrassing for you, but you would never replace me, right, Rexy? Because you love me so much, I'm the best, you don't have to tell me, but you should, so this cat knows who is the better pet.
Hello, and nice to meet you. I are Bestia.
Get along, you three. I need you to work together, okay? Harmony scares you at their toxic chirp speed. Yeah, all they hear is just like just constant sounds.
Oh, you sound like you got a job for us going on. You're here to take me on more epic adventures. Don't worry, I'll protect you, Rexman. Don't you worry about a thing. Your loyal vassal is here.
Don't be ridiculous. He didn't come for you. He came here for me because I'm his favorite.
No, I'm his favorite!
Can I be his favorite?
No, I can first!
Okay, seriously, cut it out, okay? No fighting during the war. Good rival Kika at this rate.
Sid, thank you for the raid!
Hang on, war? What are you saying, Rexman? Are you taking me into another war? Because that's so exciting. It's just like old times, right, Rexy? Do you remember?
That's a big deal, huh? It's like that Vanguard stuff. And we're doing it again? They're fighting against the cult with Rex.
If you guys are okay with sitting on the sidelines, you could stay here. But I won't be back. Maybe for a while.
Now you just add in some bat sounds with this entire conversation too.
Oh, sit on the sidelines! I know who you're talking to, Rexman! I'm your strongest vassal! Greatest ally I could ever ask for! I'm so in!
I want to go with you, Rexy. We've been apart for so long and I miss you. I love you, Rexy. Please let me come.
We're all going with you, Rex. I hope I can make more smart animal friends. I do not have any animal friends. Do they have human forms too?
Human what now? That's not something I want to think about. Okay, let's just get moving.
Oh, wow.
Why did that cat sound cocky when he meowed? Yeah, that was kind of fucking weird. What the shit? How did he do that with his meow? Hello?
How are you cocky? How is that even possible for cat?
Bug was...
Were you...
silent.
You know what? Cool.
As far as I'm aware, I don't think Bug is actually a sentient animal like the rest of them.
Bug is just a sweetie.
Has Bug joined the animal squad?
He is alive, but he doesn't have a spirit and soul like we do.
Dan, do you have that gold nugget tossed you yesterday?
No, my god.
Give him a little shiny. He likes shinies.
Yeah, he was a little treasure hoarder. Remember when we found his nest?
Yeah. There, that'll make him happy.
Everin's perched up here.
Hello. Oh my god.
What is he carving now? I swear to god.
He's always carving something.
And it's a certain shape.
That dog. I wanna ride it.
Oh my god.
You will die.
Something tells me a bad idea.
You will die, Everin. You will literally stop living. Like, I genuinely need to warn him against that because Atticus might actually kill him.
Oh my god.
Chill, Felicity. I'm sure they'll open up soon.
Oh.
The library closed.
Lily 211 wants to trade with you.
I'm just trying. No!
I was going to trade you the corn!
I have corn.
Where did my corn go?
Skill issue. Corn?
I lost my... Did I eat it?
Dude, I'll show you corn, Marshy.
I guess it is meant to be eaten.
Felicity. Please.
Oh, there we go.
It's always so boring.
Sorry, I got Lycos instead.
It's always so boring when they use the library for meetings. Whatever.
Clyde is down there. You want to do that one real quick?
Yeah. Somebody come in or she's dancing like a marshy.
So really badly.
Oh.
Get it, Marshy, because you're bad at dancing?
Yep.
No, dude, didn't you take a dancing class?
Yeah.
Marsh, you have a cloud stepper?
Oh, I do. I'll take it off. I use it to get
Tell us about your dancing class, Marshy. Tell us about your moves.
I had schmoves when I had. Was taught them.
Moves.
Had. Schmoves. You lost them all?
Yeah, because I stopped.
Huh. Why is the dog... Why did the dog move all the way over there?
And why is the dog hanging out with a bird, a cat, and a bug?
We don't question.
Just bug. You can just call them bug.
Oh, shit. No, I guess these are the people we would want to talk to, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well,
hey.
Don't mind us.
Sebaniel.
Sebaniel?
Not even his full name. It's just Seb. I just love telling him Sebaniel. It's your twin, Dan. Sebaniel.
Sebaniel. My long lost twin brother.
Vic Sebaniel and Raven.
Ian, quick, tell your brother. He can read the line.
Oh my god. Right? Vic, Seb, and Raven all stand within the library discussing something that's seemingly important.
Even with the ocean level going back down to normal, we've noticed a decrease in the fish we've managed to catch. Perhaps it's time that we build more ships and send some out in deeper depths?
Building ships takes manpower, which would take away from other construction jobs that are still necessary in Vanguard. The Mage Tower still hasn't been fully repaired.
Then I can work on the Mage Tower myself. You can transfer some of the others to build ships of limited size, 2 or 3 people, with the reserve supplies.
Hi. We interrupting.
The 3 of them look up as you enter.
Vessels! No, not at all. Please, come in.
Is there something of importance you wish to discuss with us?
Yeah, there is, actually. It's really important.
I don't see a problem with changing topics to hear them out.
If you're certain, we can always come back to the subject at a later time. For now, the farms are plenty to sustain us, but we should focus on our city's nutrition as well and consider a balanced diet for our people in the future discussions.
Agreed. But for now, vessels, what is it that you'd like to say?
We're going to war with the Edict. Officially.
Oh yeah, Seb's full name is Sebastian, isn't it? The entire room goes silent as they all glance at one another. Seb would rub his arm nervously while Raven and Vix would glance at one another.
A war?
Against the Edict? Listen, they're getting closer and closer to actually destroying the world.
A single organization, even of their size, having the power to destroy all of Rem? It seems hard to believe.
I am the protagonist.
So am I. Cam is bad.
Why? Why must you betray me so? There we go. As hard as it may be to believe, Raven, I hear that they may be correct. When we were locked within the Vault of Vanguard, I remember the ritualists often talking about this goal. The idea that they would return the world to the All-Knower, God of the Void.
Seb remains quiet, avoiding looking at anyone out of mild embarrassment. But we wanted to come to you and ask if the guards of the city would ally themselves with our cause. We wanted to lend your swords.
Thank you for the hydrate chat.
Vix sighs.
While I support your cause wholeheartedly, and I'm certain that many of the other guards would support it as well, given their own experiences, I'm just not sure if it is the wisest decision.
Vix, come on, please.
You're all feeble in comparison to me! I could hear exactly when Lila clicked it as well, and it was like a whole like 3 centuries later.
Shut up.
Also, I mastered the art of simply hitting the enter key, so, you know.
You can hit enter?
2 years of Mythos SMP.
Okay.
Did Lila accidentally skip to the next dialogue?
Yeah, the pay was too long, so now I have to re-click into it.
You're a moron. I can.
How are okay. you? I'm sick.
You know, I would like nothing more to see the Edict die. They took our original village, Aetiran. They manipulated me, and they killed Father Genesis. And then, when we were finally settling elsewhere, they took over Vanguard and locked us all away. I would be more than happy to strike them down personally, but...
Vanguard is still growing and recovering as a city. We have taken their walls, their materials, and even some of their old followers, but if we continue to... But if we follow this path toward revenge against the Edict, I'm certain that Vanguard would suffer the consequences. Our current priority... Our current prosperity... And I have to process it, okay? Our current prosperity and the happiness of our citizens would certainly decline if we forced a relatively young citadel into battle.
Wolf said that your guards are more than ready to fight.
Well, this
my
may be...
My current priority.
Well, this may be true, If you donated all our troops to your cause, who is to say that Vanguard itself would not fall without our proper protective measures?
Seb would speak up, however. So instead of taking a stand, you want us to sit by complacently with all they've done to destroy us? Destroy our spirits!
Seb.
That's not what I'm saying, Sebastian.
I was locked in that vault just like the rest of you. I know how you feel and how scared you are. I never want that to happen again. But then, what about all the other cities or towns in Mythos? The ones that don't have our walls or our guards? What if there are people locked away in their own vaults, shivering and afraid, with the edict just outside the cell doors? Thank you for the hydrate. What if we sacrifice Marchie?
I like that plan.
That's a fate I couldn't wish upon my worst enemies. And I've wished plenty of things on the edict. To be belittled, spit at, and locked away like an animal. But there are people in this world who need a helping hand, a way out. We were lucky. But there are plenty who aren't. I don't want to sit by and let them rot. I want to be just like the Vestals and do all that I can to stop that from happening to anyone else!
Thank you, Seb.
Shut up, simp.
Simp!
Oh.
Damn. I wonder if, like, there was a way to calculate how much time we waste just by, like, waiting.
It gives you a slight smile, but turning to Raven and Vix.
Seb.
I fully support the declaration of war, and I am more than willing to stand by your sides on the front lines. For Vanguard. Vix sighs, rubbing her head.
May the gods help us.
Vix?
I am Cam, not for real people, though. Wait, what did Cam say that Ndu was responding to?
What?
Oh, simp. Yeah.
I simp
for every Mythos character in existence. That's except valid. I only simp for Milfy Mallow, not normal Marshy Mallow.
Oh my god.
I was about to say same, and then you just added on that little tidbit, and...
Do you not simp for Milfy Mallow? It's my favorite image.
I really don't.
What is Milfy Mallow?
It's Marshy, but if she were a MILF.
Yeah.
But you said an image.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Yeah, there's an image.
I've never seen it.
It's Marshy, but if she were...
I've seen it. It's the greatest image I've ever drawn. Anyways, I'm not being pro-tagged, so...
None of us are.
Okay. As much as I fear the prospect of capture, or losing the prosperity, we've worked hard to gain. I agree with Sebastian.
Vix, are you sure about this?
If we cannot help those in need, who suffer as we have, can we really call ourselves the Vanguard?
She turns back to you all.
The Vanguard Cavalry is yours to command, Vessels, as it always has been.
What about the city?
Where can I see that? It's a thing that happens only in the Mythos production server.
Ooh, why
Mythos
you sent
after
me
hours.
Thick?
What? Oh my god, wait, you got sent the image and you just said so dummy thick?
Unless Candy has sent it publicly somewhere.
No, she just sent it in a DM as far as I know. So dummy thick. Yep, Milfy Mallow for you. So dummy thick. Raven crosses her arms.
I shall ensure that it continues to thrive in their absence. And I shall have the guards in training ensure its protection. The edict certainly wouldn't attack it a second time,
And if they do, we'll be ready for them this time. They'll use their own walls against them and destroy any opposition at sea. He puts a hand on the handle of his great axe confidently. I'd be more than happy to follow you, Vessels. As the cavalry's representative.
I wouldn't have it
I draw a Milfy Mallow. Go forward, my children. Produce no. many a Milfy Mallows.
No! What have you unleashed, Rex?
Sebastian, make sure to report to us on their movement and activities. If you require our numbers, they are yours. I swear it.
Thank you, Vix. And let you guys down once. I won't do it again. He gives you a confident grin. Certainly grown a lot since you first met him, hasn't he? Let's just move. We're almost done here. Maybe. Possibly.
I'm tired.
Hi, tired. I'm Rex. This funny guy.
This funny man.
Now we can go to the wall that you saw.
Skimming bottom, bottom.
Yeah, we can go to the wall of individuals.
Ooh.
Wall of individuals.
The wall of men.
Oh, wait. Maybe we can find Dusk again, because...
Baby.
Shut the fuck up, Kim. I swear to God, if you keep saying what's going to happen in the roadmap before it happens, I'm going to lose my mind.
I don't know!
Zoe!
Zoe!
This is Adriana. This is not Zoe, this is Adriana.
Zoe's right next to him, moron.
I know.
Zoe, my favorite cat girl. Are there multiple?
I've always wondered, Zoe, why do you spend so much time in the Aetherian district?
Wait a second.
It's new to them.
Me and the people from Aetherian go way back, yeah?
The best Nyalai he's ever done, but was still weak, reserved.
Well, because it's, like, really late at night.
Me and the people of Aetherian go way back, nyah?
Nyah? Me and the people of Aetherian go way back,
nyah? Oh my god! He's big! He grew up!
Dusk?
He's big! And?
Oh, you still load the cat girl voice stream?
I can chat!
Alright, that's all you get. Boom, stream done. Perhaps you talk to N first, then we're Dusk. Trying. We're all right-clicking on N.
We're trying!
And Irian would stand outside, her arms crossed as Lily will definitely fail to read all of her words. Speak to the tall, eldritch figure next to her.
I'm beginning to grow impatient with how very cold this realm is. Even their warmest temperatures are below the freezing point of the Nether. It's ridiculous that they believe the desert to be scorching. If the Mortalis Vermala of this realm truly wish to understand scorching, they should spend a mere moment within the lava lakes of Shut up!
Daimonicor, I think.
Daimonicor.
I think. I don't speak Latin.
Oh, N! Hey!
Hello.
I was waiting for Candy to praise me.
Sunk into my chair.
She glances in your directions with a raised, thank you, Candy, with your directions, the raised eyebrow before demonic eyes that quickly widen.
Deus malum sit.
Come again?
Absolute necrom villis Draylock Vermala.
She jabs a finger in Rex's direction.
All of you, Vermala. Demnarn Omnia.
Domnare Omnia.
No, Lily.
Yeah, what she said.
I'm sorry, Lily. I knew this was coming.
Neymari Omnia, to abandon myself and Dusk and Vanguard for so long with little care.
Whoa, okay, hang on. We said hi to you the other day at the record.
Have you no heart? Of course not. A daemon with no core. That is what you are in particular, Rexfitter. How could you leave your son with no pater for so long?
Son? Munda would blurt out in shock before quickly putting her hands over her mouth at her outburst. Oh. No, wait, no, no, stop. Give me a chance to explain.
Good luck, man.
I think that was an accurate statement.
London, take your hands off your mouth. London, look, I can explain. Okay. London, stop shaking your head at me, London. What?
Broke London.
Tan's dying. You found that really funny.
Yeah.
There is little for you to explain. You are truly incompetent. A worthless demon, inferior in every way to the Hellstone Dreads, even despite your silver-eyed aura.
She crosses her arms.
What pitiful explanation could exonerate you from such cruelty?
And
do not call upon my name in hopes of finding some form of comfort. If you believe me to be comforting, you've clearly ignored my existence far too long.
She lowers herself.
There is only one way to settle this dispute. Fight me to the death, Rexpeter. I shall end your immortal life now for the honor of myself in Dusk, the honor of the Hellstone Dreads. I will not be pawned in your mortal town unforgotten. Do you understand me?
Oh my god, could you chill out? We didn't forget! We were just busy!
Oh my god.
Is this what you would often call a marriage dispute?
Teal asks, raising an eyebrow.
Beat her ass, Rex!
Flux cheers for you.
Prepare yourself, for I shall not allow myself to prepare yourself. Wait, what?
Dude.
That doesn't even make sense.
Lily.
Dying.
I'm on the ground.
Lily.
You've killed Dan. We have done it.
Can you bring back the line guide? For I shall not allow myself to prepare yourself. What?
For the process.
Miley, you okay?
Prepare yourself, for I shall not allow you time to prepare yourself.
That doesn't even make sense.
I'm sorry, Lily. You're amazing. We all adore you.
We do.
Two, one, love.
It's so funny.
In Lily's defense, this is by far the hardest character to read for.
Yeah.
Lily, you okay?
She's gone. You broke Lily. She's gone.
She seems about to leap forward before a single eldritch tendril would place itself on her shoulder. And the tall being behind her would speak in a rather mature voice.
Mother, there's no need for such a show of aggression in Vanguard. I'm certain there's an explanation if you allow him time to explain.
For a dark being, you are certainly forgiving, Dusk.
I have learned well from those who have surrounded me during my growth.
Wait, Dusk? You can, like, talk in full sentences now?
Lily, hug, yeah. Please. Hug, Lily.
Character development?
Lily, please, hug. I'm not gonna be able to focus until you hug me back.
Hug.
Thank you, are you okay?
Naturally. He has been speaking at an advanced level for some time now. Had you been present for his development, you would have seen this.
Dusk walks forward.
I may assume you are here for a reason.
Two glowing orbs within his clothing would narrow at you all.
Otherwise, you would not have approached with such conviction in your fleshy countenance. Speak your minds. I guess we can use your help. Both of your helps, actually.
Thank you for the hug and the head pat.
Holy shit, puberty did good. He's a man, please.
We made a man out of him.
Let's get down to business.
Rex is a proud father.
If that is not the richest ludus I've heard in some time within this mortal realm.
Not the right character.
Oh shit.
Wow. Wow.
Oh shit. You know what assuming does, my man?
Makes an ass out of you and me. If that is not the richest ludus I've heard in some time within this mortal realm, why now would you require our assistance?
The Alacrim Edict.
Please just say shit.
How old is Dusk? I don't know, like a year? Maybe less.
Oh my god.
I'm still looking over at Rex and seeing
London. He's older than a year. He's like a year and a half.
They grow up so fast. Which Isaban arc did you get him in?
Yep. I don't know, it's the one I found in my basement, so...
That was...
Probably the
universe. How dare you know? Basement?
Well, it's in the void in my basement. It's a long story. They both pause. And Nerium herself would narrow her eyes at you.
Alacrim. That is a phrase for the organization that would capture your ocean city. Is it not? Over a year ago now?
That's right. And now they're stronger than ever before. They're threatening this entire world.
Anticipation.
That's you, Marshy. Her expression seems to falter at your statement. However, she would scoff, crossing her arms and looking away.
Why exactly should I care for this mortal realm of yours? It is not my true home, after all. You have yet to locate my true home.
Her conviction in her statement is weak, much to your surprise.
We can't help you find your home if this world is destroyed in the process, so...
Yeah, Lily
has so much dream to go.
What did I do?
I just want to go to bed.
You don't get to tonight.
Oh.
Cannot wait to tell my work tomorrow.
Oh my god. I suppose that is correct, but...
You're a Hellstone Dread, and one of the strongest warriors we know. We need your strength. She tosses her hair.
Not that I'm interested in your statement, but what exactly are you suggesting?
We want to recruit you in our war against the Edict.
No. That's a Rex thing.
How the fuck do you do that?
How do I do what?
Just whatever the fuck you're doing right now.
Big cheeks.
Goddamn.
Why didn't you start with that?
What?
I have experienced such war several times in the Nether. Despite your incompetence, you have come to the correct individual to ally yourself with. I have been itching for further combat, indeed. And my skills are unlike any other, as you yourselves may attest. I shall join you. And if I find this to be entertaining, we may consider your transgressions against a single parent waived.
You never told me you were married, Rex!
Lunted would state in a rather high-pitched voice behind you, hiding her face in her hands and turning away from you. I'm not! She's not a single parent! You know, fuck this, whatever.
Let's talk to your son.
Hey, Dan is dead.
Dan, are you okay?
Dan,
are you okay?
It's so funny.
Rex, that you're fucking shit on stream because that sounded like the wettest shard I've ever
heard. What the?
Take your time.
The tall eldritch being stands before you all, emulating a look of having his arms crossed. His body would remain wrapped in some rather elegant robes and armor to hold a humanoid shape, much like the Mystrix, but six tendrils would escape his back and hover around him. His golden eyes narrow at you as you approach.
Hello, Potter.
Dusk, you've gotten bigger.
Yes. I have. I've grown much while you were gone on your adventures.
He glances at Anirium, and then back at you.
Listen, I understand why Mater has grown angry at your absence, but I also understand why you were gone as long as you were. I am not blind to the conflict around me and Rem. I have learned much from your texts and your cultures.
So, you know what you are, and like, all of that?
Indeed. I know that when I was newly created in the void, you found me, Rex. I felt an attachment in my primitive states, not to you, but to the primordial I sensed within you. In this way, I had little objections, even at a young age, to being whisked away to your realm.
He looks around.
And now that I have been here, I've come to realize several things I am certain no others of my kind would realize. due to their attachment to the voidal darkness. One such thing would be the ability to emote as any mortal being would. And the ability to see my past self, or see past myself, rather.
Wow.
This would not have been possible without Mater, or Inurium, as her proper title is. Had she not cared for me, I'm certain I would not have become the creature I am today. Granted, I can identify certain parts of my adolescence where her teachings were not necessarily the wisest. But I understand that such is due to her very different upbringing.
Well, I mean, at least you're aware about that.
He's not even 2 years old and he's already the most mature person here. Yeah, Marshy, take notes. Less than 2 year old is beating you out.
Shit.
I'm quite aware of many things.
Yen crosses his arms.
For instance, I've overheard your reason for coming here. You wish to re-enter war against the Alacrim Edict. Yeah, they need to go down or the void will consume this world. While I am confident that I would survive such an attack from the Edict, I understand how dangerous such a goal would be.
He lowers his head.
This world, Rem, would be destroyed in the process, and darkness would return to consume everything as it had at the beginning of time. But all life would cease to exist. Admittedly, I've grown to enjoy the company of Rem's life, no matter how different we may be.
You'll help us?
Yes. I will help you in defeating your enemies. In the name of my Mater and Pater, and the world I was raised in. His tendrils would sharpen, and you swear you see a malicious grin within his features. Additionally, while I can hardly ignore the cry for bloodlust within my tendrils, while I may have been raised in your world, I retain some level of primordial lust for chaos and destruction.
You'll have plenty of time to fight Dusk. I say Flux and Teal's are Dusk Uncles. I'm not a fucking Oh my god.
I count on it. I'd like to show you what I'm capable of, Potter. If war is what it takes, then so be it. I shall not complain.
His tendrils relax, as does his humanoid form.
Thank you for choosing to include me in this, your final battle. I shall revel in defending this world alongside you.
Thanks, bud.
So
did it pass
nice.
Up Sasha and Andrew? Did Where we? Were they?
Oh, they were over here.
Yeah, they were over here.
Yeah, here they are.
Oh.
Oh, whoops.
Sorry, Vix asked us not to let anyone pass while she's at a meeting with the Ravens elsewhere.
He's going to say the exact same thing. Yeah.
Sorry, Vix asked us not to let anyone pass while she's at a meeting with Raven elsewhere.
What the fuck? Fine.
See, this is the blessing that it is.
Okay. That means I could go bed earlier.
Two rays!
Open it up, that's it. Open it up. I want more dialogue. Two rays, but which one's the real ray?
This one.
I'm calling. Neither. Neither.
The emotionless ray is guarding the outcast district. That's damn, it's neither. Say. That's gotta be that one.
Probably that one.
Axel?
Hello.
Okay. Maybe I was wrong. Ray's duplicates aren't that bad.
He would be looking toward Giga and Ray nearby. Oh, is Giga talking off a Ray clone right now? And the actual Ray's probably sleeping over there.
Yeah, I'm calling that was the actual Ray.
That is the most coherent I've ever seen, River. I'm inclined to agree.
River is an NPC.
I have been awake for too long. Help me. Now, do you mean like for today or do you mean like in general? I'm gonna beat Marshy.
Ray doesn't want to talk, so I'm skipping.
The other Ray is mindlessly listening to Giga. Giga is telling a long-winded story. And then after all the rain went away, I saw the water dipping back into the ocean, and I was like, oh wow, the ocean is dipping back down, and now I can see the docks again. But that's when I noticed all the clouds going away, and I said to myself, wow, the clouds are leaving. I haven't seen the sun in so long, and then I...
Oh my
run.
God.
Walking away, please.
Are you guys impressed? God damn, I nailed that one.
Oh, let's verify real quick. We need to verify.
Thank you for the hydrate.
Let's see if all their bets are right. Is this the real Ray?
Ray!
But she's getting angrier and angrier because she wants to go to
wake
sleep.
Wake up!
Did he just hit her? The real Ray is taking a nap.
Unbelievable. Who is that?
Quibble.
Quibble.
Quibble. You arguing with Quibble. Yourself, Quibble? Oh, and Izzy.
Oh, no.
Izzy is just creepily staring at Quibble and giggling. Oh, God.
No.
Oh, no.
Why is the child staring at us? How should I know? Did you do something? I didn't do anything. You did something. I did it. You did. You did. You did. I hate you.
Oh, my God. Relax.
God damn.
What a colorful cast of characters. The most normal one being right here. Hello, Teresa.
She's the one that makes everyone sane.
Yeah. Dad. Yeah, she is the mom friend. Then Teresa prays.
She's praying for the sanity of her people.
And herself.
Series.
Don't you ever get a bit worried about Izzy's attachment to Quibble?
Hello, Ryan. Well, it does give me a break. I know what you mean. It's a little
what
strange. Get fucked. Lynn and Florink.
Florink.
Florink!
Lynn and Florink.
We talked to Flynn or...
Lion and Florink.
Flynn?
Lion and Florink.
Lynn and Florink.
Lion and Florink. Lion and Florink.
Which one are we talking to?
Lion Florink. Whoever wants to talk first. Oh. I got Lynn.
Lynn
I got
and Florence.
Florence.
They have the same dip with fucks. Oh. Lynn and Florence would sit under the protection of the shrine with one another. Lynn would be staring at some kind of scroll, his brow furrowed in frustration. But Florence would motion to the scroll. This character. How do you say it?
If I knew that, I would have said it by now, don't you think?
Florence frowns at him, while Lynn would practically tear the paper in half.
Screw this! This is impossible!
Hang on, what's wrong?
Nothing, twin!
Whoa!
Whoa! Sorry, I got in character.
Oh, no!
Ah, yes, my
really
title.
Happy. I did her character right. They both look up toward you, glaring, while Florence seem rather indifferent at your arrival.
Nothing wrong. I was just teaching Lynn. Nothing! You are doing nothing, you hear!
Lynn quickly shoves the torn paper into his pocket in one fluid motion, ensuring you didn't see it.
The hell do you people want this time?
We came here to ask you something.
Me too.
I'm glad to be acknowledged by my title.
Did someone just shove their mic in the garbage disposal? Because who just banged against it that loud? I'm not sure.
Might have been me.
Obviously. That seems to be all you want to do when you intrude in our space.
He stands up, crossing his arms.
What did I tell you last time, huh? Quit using us just for your convenience like the damn cult did and leave us alone!
This is about the cult. It's important.
Yeah, you have no idea how many times we've had this exact conversation.
Yeah.
I know, it's a kind of recurring combo. Always we last.
You really should just have a script at this point.
Hi, I'm Russ.
NPC is broken. I just have a gray box where the character should be.
What? Oh, same. What the fuck?
Not me. I'm great.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Shut up. No one cares.
Okay.
It's always about the cult, because you can't do your job yourselves. He growls. I told you before. Back in the rain, just let us fucking live our lives here in peace. We don't want anything more to do with the cult, don't you get that? He grabs Florence by the hand. Come on, Florence, let's go. We're going to war with the Lacrim Edict.
He was so angry, he caused thunder.
Yeah.
Jesus.
He angry.
Marshy's no nipples, by the way.
Yeah, it's true.
It's just skin.
Yep.
Not a single nip. Not one.
None.
It's actually on her forehead.
Yep.
Lynn immediately freezes in his place. Florence looks back at you all.
What? With the Lacrim Edict.
And his tone goes surprisingly quiet. You notice that everything around you would also grow more quiet as the various individuals of the outcast would look toward you.
Did they just say
we're going to war?
That's insane. Sorry, I voiced Cerise, so I took both of them.
It's no joke. We're officially declaring war on the Edict today.
I see that you're very soon in my chat.
Lynn looks back at you all, his eyes widened and his expression unreadable.
And you're more stupid than I thought. You're not gonna win. You're just gonna get yourselves killed. Or, I guess since you're immortal, you get yourselves caught and everyone else killed.
I think we could do it.
Can it, bozo? Oh.
Danny DeVito, the one that we need. That's Marshy's theme song.
Marshy the
Dicks out for Harambe. Dicks out for Harambe. Again, dicks out for Harambe. Dicks out for Harambe.
I'm telling you that you can't. Maybe you could beat that Supreme Rituals of Aqua, and maybe you could kick them out of Vanguard. But taking on the entire Lacrim Edict means you have to take down Rowan. And that's not a fight you're gonna win. Then, maybe. Shut it, Flo! If I couldn't win against him, then how are they supposed to, huh?
We're stronger than you think.
Oh yeah, soft boy. I can throw you in this ocean and you'll sink like a rock.
Oh my fucking god.
I unironically thought you just read a line.
Oh my god.
You thought you wrote that? Hello?
No, and that's why I was confused. I was like, I did not write something that Chad.
Hello and welcome, Crochet.
I'd like to see you try, bitch.
I'm sure you do, but that's why it took six of you to defeat one of his underlings.
He raises his arm, speaking all of the outcasts.
But I think we all know how much stronger Rowan is than the people who work under him. Are you really expecting us to jump at joy now that you think you have what it takes? Don't make me laugh.
Listen, we could defeat him if we all work together, like...
Shut up, chicken!
I'm not fucking chicken!
Oh my god.
I think he's just going through something. Let him just keep going.
No, this is him all the time!
Hey, Lynn, do you need to talk? Are you okay?
After boy.
I think he needs therapy.
I don't think he expected me to scream that loud back.
I think he needs therapy.
I think I might caught him off guard by how loud I yelled back.
You can't! There are a few things in this world I can't defeat. When I'm telling you that you can't defeat him, I'm... Lynn. Your hand.
Lynn pauses, looking down at his hand. You notice that his hand would be shaking.
This is like what happened last time. Are you scared of Rowan?
I'm not scared of anything. Don't be ridiculous.
Then it's okay to be scared after what he did. You don't have to.
I'm not scared, do you hear me?
Then why was your hand shaking? Rex approaches Lin, who stares at him in anger, gritting his teeth. I get it. You're scared after what he did to you, all of you. Shut your damn mouth. But if we work together and help defeat him, then you people won't have to fear him anymore. The outcasts all glance at one another quietly. Get the hell out of our fucking district, you pieces of shit. Rowan is working on destroying this world as we speak. The All-Knower is coming. Man, I was almost comboing it pretty well.
No.
Yeah, I still haven't seen the dialogue that you just read. I still haven't seen it
yet. I'm like two dialogues behind.
Several outcasts start to mutter when you announce this news.
The All-Knower? What do you mean he's on the way?
The Dark God? He's rising up from the bottom of the world! Soon he'll rip forth the ground and all the stars will go out!
Please tell me this is a joke!
We can still stop him, though, if you join us in our war against them.
Even Izzy knows.
Jeez.
The chat's trying to console me. They're like saying it's hard to accept what you are, but it's okay to be a chicken. God damn it.
You call her CFC, Cam Fried Chicken.
No!
We're not joining any damn war, do you hear me? You're leaving us out of this!
But would our efforts really be of service to your efforts, Vessels?
Teresa, you can't agree to this. I'm with Lithlet on this. We promised we'd stay out of this sort of thing.
But what if our interference helps people? I don't want anyone else in the world to suffer as we have under the Edict. It wouldn't be fair. We should at least try to help, right?
This isn't just a Vanguard rebellion. This is a push and pull between our territories.
So you really just want to sit around and do nothing? Is that how you want to live your lives?
They all glance at one another. That's all we've wanted. We just wanted to live our lives normally. We didn't want to think about the Edict anymore. We didn't want to be part of their business. And we didn't want to be their tools.
But if I can use this life to stop anyone else from being a tool for their endeavors, I would be more than happy to do so.
So would I.
Whose side are you on? I'm the leader of this group, you hear? Look, I'm not going to tell you what to do, okay? But this is your chance, not just for revenge, but closure. To resolve all of these issues. You're gonna live your entire life living in that shadow, living in that fear, unless you act against it.
Closure.
Florence pauses, looking down.
Been running for so long. Tired of running from her killer. My lady didn't deserve to die.
Flo, come on, you can't be serious! We can work together. I can protect you in this war, and we can fight together, all right? And we can teach you other things, too. Can we give Linner the Edict to Wilkins? Oh, my God. Oh, no. Wilkins raid boss?
Oh. Now I'm being called Angelic Chicken.
What the hell is that supposed to mean, huh? You stare at Lin for some time, your eyes slowly moving down to his pocket where the paper is. I saw your practice journal, Lin. Great! So everyone is snooping through my business now, huh? How long were you captive of the Edict? So what, you fear them? Shut up! Just shut up, goddammit! He snaps. The other outcasts look over at him as his voice would almost crack. I've had it up to here with you damn vessels shoving your way into our business! And pretending to know what we've been through! Why is it so hard for you to just leave us alone? Why is it so hard for me to just get away from it all, goddammit! Lin pants a bit at you, all of you, before Ray would approach the scene. Lin glances back at him. Ray? Ray clears their throat.
Eh.
war can't be all that bad, right? Not like we haven't fought a bunch of ritualists already. So what the hell? Why not do what we do best? They made us to fight, so... Let's fight.
It's your choice, Lynn.
The laziest guy here wants to fight.
Nice.
I mean, damn.
Lynn would still hesitate for some time before. Very slowly, he would reach into his pocket. He stares at the paper before glancing up at you. And you sure someone will teach me how to read this?
Yes, and if you want to, we can also teach you how to write.
He looks around at all the outcasts. He would seem a bit more confident around him. He growls.
Damn it! Fine, goddammit! We're going to fucking war, I guess!
Glad to have you on board.
Glad to see your dialogue.
Glad to lick your balls, Marshy.
The outcasts all begin to cheer with one another. Florence gives a small smile to Lynn.
Proud of you.
Shut the hell up. I didn't just do this for me. He looks over at the other outcast. If that's what they want, then fuck it. That's what we'll do.
Yeah, it's so bad after all.
Come here, Marshy! Bring me those balls!
So they're gonna hold this entire conversation.
What,
Lily?
I've been a single dialogue behind for almost this entire conversation. Barely looking out every time I have to speak.
Better than Bozo.
Oy.
Okay. So now we should head back, right?
Where?
Onto the castle. You recruited everyone.
Marshy.
Oh. Shit,
I can't think of anyone else that we could really go for right now, right?
Like, should we at some point tell other vessels to recruit people?
Yeah.
Like, if I run it?
Over like, time.
Just let me know if you need me to, like.
And I mean, we've already talked to everyone. Vanguard, Raven Guard. It's not like we can go out to East Haven for help.
That's a
little too. Where's Lily?
Hi.
In the boat, Cam.
Okay. So where else then?
I mean, is there anyone nearby or
no,
something?
There isn't really.
We already have Wyrin and Tabby.
There's Trivago if you want to stop there.
And it's not like there's anything else out in the middle of the
way.
Do we have to?
Let's go.
So they're parked off the coast, right?
I don't know where we're going.
Are we gonna go to the fucking pirate ship?
Oh, that place.
Yes!
We didn't mention her earlier.
Don't sound so excited. They're
thanks
not
for reminding me then, Lily.
What did I do to remind you?
When we were
I
talking about Ren earlier. If you didn't do that, I wouldn't have remembered that she might still be
I'm
around here.
On the opposite side of it. Oh my god.
I'm just happy
swim.
That we're gonna go into the fucking pirate ship. I'm so excited.
What's the easiest path I can take?
Just that's believe in yourself.
You know what?
Yep, Ren.
I'm gonna go
as
play
long as
survival
she doesn't
Minecraft
act like an asshole, it'll be fine.
It's Ren. Just suck it up, yeah.
Well, you could be 10 times
those pirates can be like really useful.
Convenient crafting table.
Probably for people like you without boats.
I don't fucking go to Vanguard, bro.
Gan's so happy. His enthusiasm was infectious because my entire chat's going yippee.
Yippee! Yeah!
Look at this chat.
I am
Minecraft
so happy about the pirate ship.
SMP could not.
Don't act like you're not about to get TP'd anyway, Marshy.
This tree is going to just stay here like this because I'm not breaking the leaves.
You're a monster!
Well, it doesn't go away because we have it fucking turned off because of Gaia.
Well, there it is!
Here we go, we're at the ship. TP Marshy soon.
I have a boat!
Yeah, no. But I'm not waiting for your slow ass.
I'm on the way.
Wait, but you're gonna lose the boat when you get
TP'd
now.
Too good, Rifted Dad.
Alright, TP Marshy, let's go.
Tokyo Drift Dan.
Do you think Tokyo you could Drifting. Recruit Jim?
Oh, that was like laggy. That was laggy as hell. Oh, TP shit.
Marshy.
My boat just disappeared.
Ah, shit, I got my boat robbed.
Oh, did I accidentally? Oh, so sorry.
Give me your boat. Okay.
TP Marshy.
We continue.
TP Marshy! Okay.
Oh my god.
There she goes. Idiot.
Oh, it's been a while since I've been
Give me
here.
Boat back.
Yeah. Oh, yep.
Give me boat back. Who has boat? Give it back.
I have the boat I have boat. But I Hold don't on. Know where the other
Daniel.
One is.
Here, sorry, I'm looking at the big-ass boat that we're on, Rex.
No,
boat,
yeah, you've missed
boat,
this.
Boat.
Look,
boat,
they
boat.
All have one-offs, guys.
Whoa.
Oh my god. It's you guys. It's been so long. yeah. I actually really wouldn't, I really want to talk to Ren right now. Please don't.
What?
Oh boy.
I think we got impeccable Jaylen. Timing.
They're, what do you call the person that steers the ship? Jaylen. Please tell me no one's in the crow's nest. I don't want to check.
I don't want to check.
There's a crow's nest?
You can fly, go.
I will go!
Oh, no one is.
Dan's just gonna check it out while we check Jaylen, I guess. Nope, no, Dan's coming, okay.
Are those iron loops supposed to have ropes in them? Man, it's been so long since we've set sail on this ship. Hey, I know you guys. It's been a while.
Oh boy.
I think it's a person.
Diane. Was this the sus one? No, this is the British one. The insane one is Rose.
Maybe
remember.
Later. Maybe later.
I'll get in there.
The actual sociopath is Rose. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Oof.
Who just oof?
It's my Margie impression. You guys like it? I just slap my mic and then I make an oof sound.
There's a smaller boat on the bigger boat.
Yeah, there. It used to be two, but someone was so lazy they never willed that into the second pickle.
Do you think? We've had to spend so many nights in Sparrow's village during the rainstorm, and now we've been indebted to them.
Sparrow's.
What?
Is it Sparrow's village?
Oh.
Someone else can read.
No, Lily, come back. No.
Random kazoo.
No, Lily. No, I want you to read. Please. Lily. Lily.
Okay.
Yay, thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Do you think we've had to spend so many nights in Snowspell Village during the rainstorm? Now we've been indebted to them. Wasn't Ellis supposed to watch the captain's drinking habits? I cannot keep an eye on everything in the ship.
You're getting better at that British accent.
Don't throw me a pity bone.
If it's not pity, you are. I'm throwing you a pity bone by not calling out the fact that you said I instead of eagle eye.
You just...
Well, you brought the pity thing. You did that to yourself, okay?
Hello, Rose.
Hello, Rose. Lily, come back. Lily, please. Hi. Hi. Hello. Hi. Hi. Hello. Hi. Hello.
Why are you playing peekaboo?
Because you can't stay mad at me. Hi. Are you happy? Hi. Oh shit.
Oh my god, why are there so many? I clicked it once.
Just the sails, yeah? You wanna see it whisked away like in that rainstorm a while back? Hey you, get back to- Oh. It's... you. She pauses in shock. I almost forgot you existed. I'm sure the feeling is mutual, huh?
Oh, I wish it was.
Apparently Cam didn't want to speak.
Cam does that a lot. It's like silent to a woman for like an hour and she just doesn't breathe a word.
Dialogue, please.
It's been so long since I've heard it be called a noob tower. I always called it a nerd pole when I was young.
Nerd pole's my favorite.
The young woman picks her teeth with a fishbone while sorting through some barrels of TNT.
Yay.
Ooh.
Did Dan get lost? Did you go up to the crow's nest, Dan?
No, I went into the wrong room.
Hey guys, check out these barrels. Once upon a time, I said put gunpowder in the barrels, and Kat was like, I didn't know
want to do that. My name is Kat. I'm so bad.
I'm just myself.
Oh, I'm going to hop down into the hole. Oh, wait, no, there's a person.
Hey,
there.
Look, it's Ellis.
Hi. I'm falling asleep.
Please.
That wake you up?
No.
What about this?
Probably because I'm sick and I got like maybe 5 hours of sleep last night.
Okay, maybe you have your left. Second boat back.
Yay!
Smell it! Oh, while it loads. Oh. Yo.
Nice.
Place for the boat. Anyone else? Tori.
I think
I saw
someone. Yes, down. Isn't there a cook around here? Oh, here's a mirror.
Cam?
Another fine feast for a pirate, eh, Bonnie? It feels great to be back on the ship with all the cannons.
Okay, how? Why? What? Why? How do you always consistently get in dialogues?
I move fast and efficiently. You guys, Bonnie's back here. Okay, there they all go.
Bye.
Oh, rip.
What? Oh, fuck. I was spam clicking and then I lost crashing. My cake.
Never You're not. Good. Shut up, moron.
There it is. Bonnie! Pick you.
The young woman is humming, sorry. Making dinner as usual. Glad you like it, Amir.
I forgot I was the only one here.
Yeah, these two dumbs and dumbasses went to the bottom floor instead of talking to the person there.
Oh, scary.
Are you kidding me? I was supposed to clean up all the water down here by myself. Now it's no fair.
Everyone?
Yeah, I think that's all the women.
Wait, Rex, I have a theory. Or at least a hypothesis.
What?
Look what's on the table.
Yeah, she's not coming here, Bozo.
It was at least a hypothesis, you know?
That requires just going down a lot of set of stairs. She's way too lazy for that, frankly.
Iris?
Iris?
Oh, I thought you were talking about
It was a wooden cup!
No.
I thought you were pointing at, like, some drink or something.
Let's bother Ren when she's in a bad mood. This doesn't seem like a bad idea.
Sacrifice.
Hey, Dan, have you ever met Ren?
Oh, no. Fuck, no. Sorry.
You're gonna regret it.
What did I do?
Hi, Ren.
Hello.
How's Alphonse?
There's Alphonse.
Holy shit, Marcy spread a sickness to the game with how much Rex be coughing.
She still has a map of Vanguard.
Oh, yeah, she always did want to take over your city, huh?
Yeah, that did happen.
Yeah, but you didn't want to take over your city, huh?
Yeah, but Dan, it's really not accurate anymore.
Yeah, the walls aren't even there.
Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah.
Fan to dickhead! What?
Ren would be pacing in her office, her hat crooked and a bottle of gin on her desk near Alphonse, her parrot. The parrot repeats,
Mark, dickhead, what?
I know, right? And then become late dickheads. Now, all because of a little drinking, I'm indebted to no snow spell village. Me? They were under my boot last night, before last night.
What? I'm so lonely, what?
Hey, I'm not that lonely, you damn parrot. Where do you hear that one from?
What? I'll die alone, what?
Oh, God, Ren.
Is it supposed to be a tree?
I forget, she gets drunk.
Oh.
Is this one supposed to be a tree and it got broken? Who?
This dialogue was not written at a pace seat. I said anytime after dawn. I did not pace that. I didn't even see red dialogue. Candy, I literally said anything that was before dawn, I did. This is after dawn.
Thank you for the follow. Welcome to the chaos.
I swear, this was actually not me.
Thank you, Kat.
I'm going to be honest, I have no idea what's going on. Does anyone?
No.
Kat fixed it.
Yep.
Ren.
Lily, Ren. Yeah, she is. Great. Hi, Lily.
Ren.
Hello, Lily. Hi. Hi. Hey.
Ren.
Hello. Hey.
Hey.
You good there, Ren?
She quickly looks up at you all. You. She narrows her eyes, mildly wobbling in your direction. Huh.
Oh, she's drunk.
Before you can react, she picks up a small cup of ink from her desk, discarding the quill before immediately throwing the ink cup at you.
The fuck? Dan has a shield!
Yep.
Oh, you have ink all over you now.
You little ink boy. Quickly, add ink to your skin.
Oh, fuck.
But the amount of pauses I think you can do.
Yeah, yeah, maybe. Hold on, let's see.
You probably get away with it pretty quickly.
Send it to one of the backstage to do the NPM URL.
You
thing.
Quickly all avoid the ink cup, fuck.
Damn it, never
allowing the ink to spill on the wall behind you. Oh, shit, you're actually real.
What did you think we were?
What?
I was really hoping you were just hallucinations. Ugh. Oh, fuck. She groans, sitting down in her captain's chair and putting her feet up on the table. Because now that I know you're actually here, I gotta prepare my brain for you annoying me just like old times. Yeah, right. Annoying you. Because it was never the other way around, considering you still have a map of my city on the fucking table, which you were trying to take over. Always me. Always me. Cool. Annoying, of course.
You're a local person, 193. Thank you for following. Welcome to the chat.
Yep. It's already started. I can feel the migraine coming on real fast. Maybe that's just the hangover. She leans back in the chair. What the hell do you want, huh? We haven't talked since that big Florencia mess, and now you're suddenly knocking at my door? Are you really that obsessed with me?
I'm going to ask you something. It's important. Can you kill Marshy for me?
Mm-hmm. She will say yes, probably.
If only you were here for yesterday and really long explanations, yeah.
There was
the kill time while Lily, not Lily, while Candy was being a bozo. Is this stream SMP?
Oh god.
Just keep going.
Oh, thank you for the hydrate, Tori.
Oh, it's important. Well, I can hardly argue if you say it's important. She's clearly isn't taking this very seriously. The parrot squawks.
Important, important, what?
We want you to go to war with us as our ally.
Shut up.
What are you doing?
Pro tip, Lily, you should probably click the dialogue in advance so that you can get into the next one to keep reading, you know? That's how you be the protagonist. You feel me?
Do you have any other fun tips you want me to write down?
What?
She stares at you for some time, her hazy eyes looking over each and every one of you. However, eventually she would begin to laugh. Oh, that's rich. We're not joking, Brad, at all. Don't know why you would think
in the next dimension. Why is Tommy in it not screaming about discs? Oh my god. I know I'm like getting trolled right now, but this is just amusing. Cat, why? A wall. Just an actual wall.
You're serious? She snickers, adjusting herself in her chair as she leans forward, resting the elbow on her knee. Her elbow on her knee. You really want my crew to go to war? With you? Don't you remember what happened when we worked together last time? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. You cried over your ex-boyfriend and drank a lot uselessly?
Oh my god.
I remember. Hard to forget.
This stream. It's like a whole extra hour because of these pauses.
Her expression shifts to one of anger. You gave away Florencia to hunters over me. And let's not forget to mention you constantly undercut my orders to my crew. What makes you think I want to go to war with you? Hmm?
You used to be a soldier in East Haven. Could still use your skills.
Thank you for following your
lead. I am the protagonist. Dude, I'm about to leap out of my window.
I should get like a stopwatch. And just click the dialogue. I'm waiting on a dialogue. Add time to it.
I'm gonna make an edit where I cut out all dialogue and only leave the pauses, see how long it is.
Just click the dialogue options earlier so that we could just keep reading.
I haven't done that in a long time. I'd forget it if I were you. She leans back in her chair once more. The answer's no. We aren't allies, and we never were. So just get the hell out of my room and off my ship, yeah? I ain't interested in your Vanguard business anymore.
Listen, this means life or death. The world might end if we don't get more help.
Yeah, this time I'm getting diffed, so.
Same.
Didn't click it early enough.
Yeah, same. I clicked it early enough, so that's probably why.
I think it's just the first person that clicks it gets in first.
It's not that.
Oh, it isn't?
Just you gotta click it early enough.
Festive. You really think I'll believe that? The world's been spinning this long, so it's not like it'll stop anytime soon. She rolls her eyes. Have a little more respect for me, yeah? I'm not that stupid. Ah. More respect for you. What do you have to respect?
Oh my god.
Her expression darkens once more in her drunken stupor.
Miley, maybe that's a little much.
Lily. What did I say on the boat before we got here? Hello? She's not listening to me.
When do you say space buns? You heard me, Captain Drinks-a-Lot. That isn't a line you want to cross, bitch. She stands up from her chair. Get the hell off my ship. Oh, yeah. Sorry, how about, why don't you try making me run? Or am I too vanilla for you to fight?
I just want to eat dinner.
No, you starve, Marshy.
That's all I want to do.
Starve to death.
She draws her sword. I'm not about to get respected in my own damn cabin by some worthless immortal beings who don't even know how to spend a couple of postcards or keep their mouth shut. Why don't you prove to me why I'm supposed to drop everything and help you, huh? I'd be more than happy to.
Lily.
Lily.
This is on you, man.
Lily.
What?
This is on you.
Lily.
What?
Nah, bro.
She's behind you. She's...
Oh my god, Ren.
She's strong.
Ren. Oh my god.
Yeah, she is strong.
Oh, let's just stand back.
You shot me.
You think I care?
How about we go over here? Over here might be a little better.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. Gun.
Yeah. I forgot she has one of those.
Yeah. Luckily, I know what a gun looks like.
That might be smarter.
Oh my god.
Where the fuck did she go?
Outside, Bozo.
She said, "Let's take it outside." At least we got a viewing area.
We're gonna go up here.
Yeah, exactly. We got a viewing area.
Yeah, I get to watch this shit storm.
You know what? While this happens, I'm gonna go get food.
Yeah, sure. Because I don't know how long it's gonna take until either Lily gives up, Ren passes out drunk, or some other resolution happens. I don't know.
Is that all I got? Really?
Who's really? Running on?
You're so drunk, you can't even shoot straight, practically.
Rex.
Yep.
Who's your money on?
I want to say Lily, but how is she fighting well while she's drunk?
Okay, yeah.
It's kind of impressive, yeah.
Yeah, that actually is. Oh, they just...
And she just fell down the stairs.
But recovered fine.
Whoa.
What the fuck? She got the hops. The railing.
She got the hops.
And she's drunk? Lily, come on. Lily. And now she just stood in fire.
The only way that Lily's winning this is if Ren passes out.
Wow, thanks for the vote of confidence, Cam.
No problem.
She moves quickly, though. I can't tell if it's because she's stumbling everywhere or if it's because she's innately fast. It might be a mix of both. But Lily keeps shooting wide because of it.
You're right, she is a good fighter.
Yeah, and she's got that insane cutlass as well.
Yeah, I will say Ren has range and close combat.
Why did you do this, Lily? Why did this have to end in a brawl?
Because she's being a dick.
Okay, fair.
That's not a valid reason.
She is slurring all of her words. She's hitting your after image right now.
She's literally calling you a bish. Not even a bitch, a bish.
Yeah, I think she's...
Maybe the secret is alcohol. Lily, get drunk.
Let's not that, actually.
Dan,
Lily, you're breaking her shit.
Dan, I gave you the whiskey.
I'm not
Don't make a delivery, Dan.
I'm not doing that.
Man, this is just fucking...
Now you're both on fire. Oh, shit.
Oh, God.
Jesus Christ.
At least there's water around.
Yeah,
you wanna jump board?
Here's the thing. On fire ship, having to jump into the water, not exactly the...
Man, and I thought I was stubborn.
Should I go try and put out the fire at least?
Nah, I think
did she just hit on you? What the fuck is going on right now?
What the fuck?
This is a...
I don't even know what she's saying.
What the fuck is going on right now?
I have no idea, man. I'm just witnessing this.
I'm witnessing... This is a cat fight. This is an actual cat fight.
It really is.
One of them is drunk.
Are you winning, son?
Like, I've seen fist fights,
well,
Cece's tone is winning.
Off the edge.
Oh, shit.
She
caught herself on the side of the ship.
Oh, my God.
This is getting juicy.
I don't feel like I'm watching Pirates of the Caribbean. She just, like, grabbed a rope and it climbed back up.
Yeah, exactly. Wait, I just realized I can do something.
There are three options? Guys, come on, focus on the Lily fight. Well, you're ended now. Congratulations.
I got a better view.
Yeah.
Wings work sometimes.
Ascension! Celebratory ascension for Lily's cat fight with Ren. Oh my god. Can you ladies wrap this up before one of you hurt each other? Or rather, before you hurt her? Lily, we kind of need her on our side.
Yeah, we kind of need her.
Fine.
Are they done? Are they actually done?
It seems like they're done.
Well, he's on fire, but that's okay.
That's normal.
Two ascensions, three, yeah.
It's supposed to be two on one.
Yeah, fucking what do you want from me, bro, right? Well, I can only be one culture at one time. Where the fuck is Daniel? Where was he perched? Daniel, come chat with Rainbow Trains.
I went up to the crow's nest to see if the fight would last longer, and I did, and now all the way up here. Fuck.
Mistake.
I did make a mistake. I'm also
here to be spoken with, Daniel Trades. You're taking a stupendously long time.
Here we go.
Ren stares at you all in surprise following the battle before eventually she begin to chuckle and laugh. Oh man, isn't this just rich? What do you mean by that?
Gotta click earlier. Because I'm the protagonist.
Bruh.
Do you want to go to sleep tonight? It's a difference between hitting enter early or hitting enter late is whether you get to go to sleep tonight.
I hit it early and it's still delayed. You gotta hit it while they're doing the dialogue.
Here we are fighting and being all pissy. Okay, okay, good, good. When the world is apparently about to end. Man, that's pretty character-y, isn't it?
Thank you, Chomper, for following.
What?
Nah, did I click late for that one?
Hey, that wasn't a bad fight, Buns. It knocked me right out of my hangover, in fact. She winks at you. You've gotten some guts, certainly. Someone hasn't stood up to me like that in quite a while. Even though you're still a bitch. You're a bitch I can respect, you know? Huh.
I'm massively diffed right now. There we go.
Same.
She puts her hands on her hips. So, what's this about a war?
Oh, wow. You changed your mind quickly. You're just gonna casually go with us now? Huh?
Like I said, that fight helped me to, think a little bit more. And if I can find a bit of respect in my cold, dead heart for your friend there, I guess I can find the compassion in my heart to help you out of a bind. After all, despite the fact that you kind of betrayed me by giving Florencia to me, you did help me in a lot of other ways. Me and my crew. So, what the hell? I could donate a couple of pair of hands, and if it means the world doesn't explode. That's what's going on, right?
Yeah, close enough. Close enough. Close enough.
I hit enter, like, at the start of this dialogue.
Oh.
There we go.
So, give me the scoop, yeah? I can't exactly help you if I don't know what's going on, what I'm doing.
We have a floating castle near the Palencia to the west. Know it?
Yeah. I've been around there, I think. Wait, floating castle. Hang on. Back up a bit, okay? I think I missed the part where you explained how you got a floating castle above a mythos peninsula.
No, don't hit her, you fucking woman. It's okay, Lily.
No, she's not.
You're doing great.
I finished the line.
No.
Oh, I didn't get to read mine because I hit enter to prepare myself because I didn't know it was going to end right there, and then I just went out. Oh, cool. Explain everything up there, all right? We'll meet you there. All right, thank God. Now to Ravengard so that we can go back. Holy shit, we're so close.
Dan, get in the boat.
Go, moron.
Where the fuck are you?
Okay. Dan, get in the boat.
If gods want to save time, they will TPS Ravengard. That'd be a cool
thing
to do.
Wait, let me grab my boat.
No, do not grab the boat. Ah, fuck.
I got my boat.
Please, thank you. Take care, Graham.
What the fuck?
Blah!
The missing chunks. Oh.
We've been TP'd in front of...
Oh, person. There I go.
Griffin.
Hello.
Griffin be Riffin.
Don't say that.
Griffin would pace in front of the library, his hand on his chin. He grimaces a bit. As you approach, he notices you all and quickly rushes over. Hey, you guys, I got some news.
Yeah, what's up, Griffin?
He holds up a letter. Got a response from Rorik. Thought you'd want to see it. Hands you the letter carefully, allowing you to read it. Keep eating and die.
Fuck
a letter,
you.
Huh? Rorik's response reads as follows. Griffin and the vessels. Been a while, hasn't it? Unfortunately, due to a couple complicated circumstances, I can't exactly just come and see you. You're gonna have to come and see me. If you want to chat about this whole war thing or whatever, you'll have to find me. I'll meet you at these coordinates, so make sure to write them down, yeah? Yeah, told you I could get a hold of him. I guess that means you owe me a thank you. He grins at you all.
Don't push it.
He immediately frowns. Thanks, Griffin. Meet us up at the castle. We'll get Rorik. Alright, do you remember the coordinates? I vote we do a fade, get TP'd, and then fade back
in.
Yeah! Alright, guys, let's go to those coordinates.
Yes.
Where's those coordinates?
No, ka-chow.
This is far north.
Jeez.
Yeah, this is far.
And it's a cave.
Why is he in a cave?
This is the right place, right? Yep.
You wouldn't be surprised if he gave us the wrong coordinates.
Yeah, went to a cave. Nope, he is in a cave.
Why are you in a cave? Don't give me that look.
Cave gremlin.
Secret meeting location. God damn.
Cave gremlin. Will you speak to us?
Is it over? Not yet, nah. You're going for 3 more hours. Urquhart stands in the cave, his arms crossed. He grins as you all approach. Ah, well, if it isn't the vessels. Long time no see him. He gives you a small wave. Glad you managed to find the place. Rorik, good to see you. He puts his hands in his pockets. I gotta say, I didn't expect to hear from Griffin anytime soon. I assumed he was done with any of the bandit stuff. And yet, who do I find messaging me about some war? He withdraws Griffin's letter from his pocket. Color me surprised, and even a bit impressed.
So, what do you think?
I think you look stupid, Floofs.
Okay.
Well. I think it's a little idealistic. He tosses the paper aside. Declaring war against the Alacrim Edict? Don't get me wrong, we both made quick enemies of those guys. You, more than me. I'm all for beating down a couple more ritualists, but war. Wow, that's a deceivingly small word for such a really big thing. Know what I mean?
I guess.
You got any more of a plan than that? Or are you really just flying by the seat of your pants? Leans against a nearby cavern wall. I mean, there's a big difference between doing something out of spite with no plan and doing something out of spite with a plan. Know what I'm saying? Look, we're gathering together a team at a castle near Ravengard. A castle, huh? That's grand. Doesn't seem entirely impressed. I mean, don't get me wrong. It's nice to have a base of operations, but is that all you have going for you? And I declared my own mini-war against you vessels. Remember that? Good times. I had a plan A, all the way to plan Z. For instance, I knew that when I invaded Rex's mindscape, I couldn't exactly have his friends getting in the way, so I may or may not have trapped Lily in a nightmare and captured Kim and... What was your name again, Floofs? Marshy.
You fucking what?
Not again.
I find Rorik to be a funny little guy.
He's a little scrunkly.
But it was all in good fun, because Cap fucked up this dialogue, too. You know? Come on. I'm a riot. Point is, I thought everything through before I messed with you. And you think it through before you, you know, declared war on a... Mythos superpower? Did you think any of this through? Now I gotta leave and reopen the whole thing because Cat is bad. Kiba, you can't.
What did I do?
The server in the background. You don't need to be offline if we're working. You can still be on. And you still fucked it up, Kat. The dialogue has no connection. God damn it, Cam. I can't believe you fucked up this dialogue. Oh, you weren't though? Because it was Cam? You're right. Cam, god damn it.
This is the last time I paced for two different streams at the same time.
No, it's fine to pace. You did yourself. It's like, if anything goes wrong, blame me. It's my fault. All my fault. And as soon as something goes wrong, blame me.
That's who you should blame. My name's Kat, and I love ruining everything. It's my favorite pastime. My name's Kat.
My name is Kat.
Love ruining everything.
And I'm jumping around with rats.
Say in chat once you fix it, Bozo.
7-foot rats, rats along.
7-foot rats.
When you calls your rats, it all fades to rats. Yeah, he sees your rats and feasts on your rats.
I think it's fixed and then I see B. I don't see the rest. I can't check because of the... dumb lag.
I saw dumb lag twice.
7-foot cat. But it was all in good fun, you know? Come on, admit it. I'm a riot. Point is, I thought everything through before I messed with you.
Yeah, think it through before you... You know, declared war on a mythos superpower. Did you think any of this through?
You don't believe in us. And I didn't hit this dialogue early enough.
Ah, I'm the protag.
Is that a sigh of relief or a sigh of pain, Mike. Then?
Both.
How are you doing today? Welcome to Mythos S&P.
100 bottles of flux on the wall, 100 bottles of flux. Take one down, pass it around, drink till the flux runs out. 99 bottles of flux on the wall, 99 bottles of flux. Hey, don't get me wrong. I see, I get what you vessels are capable of through and through. I've seen your accomplishments, your failures. But from where I'm sitting, it's almost like, seems like you're underestimating your enemy. And we all know what happens when you underestimate. Remember? The same ones underestimated me. And look where that got you.
Well, it got us to defeat you, if I remember correctly.
Is your name Space Buns?
I have been called that.
Space Buns, Chicken, and Floofs. Okay, that was only because you invaded my memories, Lily, and I wasn't necessarily happy about that, so... Maybe I got a little carried away. He frowns. But this is different. This is the edict we're talking about. So it makes you think you've got what it takes to defeat him. There's a long moment of silence. Before Rourke would just laugh. Oh my god. Those looks on your faces. Did you think it was actually serious? My standards aren't that high. I may be the leader of the Night Raiders, but I'm still a bandit at the end of the day. It's like I said last time we saw each other. I'm on your team. I mean, I didn't really have many other choices after I betrayed the edict, did I?
Right.
So you just spent however long fucking with us. Plus, edict isn't necessarily happy with me right now.
what are you on about?
Let's just say he begins to knock on a door in the wall of the cave, revealing the smallest base you've ever seen. I'm kind of in hiding right now. You're sleeping in a cave. If you think this is bad, you see the other Night Raiders. Yeah, not too long ago, the Edict totally invaded our camps. All of our camps. I mean, after we betrayed them and defended you people, it's pretty clear they would rather wipe us off the map than let us stick around, so... Oh, how the mighty fall.
No kidding.
So, what's this about a Gazelle? Because let me tell you, it's a massive upgrade from a literal cave! He looks in his room. Spider-Girl in my sleeping bag the other night, and let me tell you, I was not okay with it! The castle has beds. You can stay there. You know where the other Night Raiders are? I can certainly find them. They keep in touch, even if we're a little separated at the moment. I'll meet you at that castle of yours, yeah? Don't wait up. And see you there.
Classic asshole.
Just, oh my know, god.
A game before
oh
agreeing.
My god.
Kaylee Vids, thank you for following.
Guys. Oh, you're sleeping in the floor, my guy.
It's this hidey hole.
Little,
oh my
a
god.
A literal hole.
My dude.
Oh. This guy in this conditions, and yet he still acts unimpressed whenever we tell him about a castle. Man, he's such a good fucking actor. I forgot how much of a little dick this guy is.
He's a dick.
Oh my god, Arky.
Oh my god.
Where are we going? Back to the castle?
Yeah, yeah. I think we can have, you know, a dramatic sequence.
We want.
We sat a long day today. We can carry onward tomorrow and talk to more people, but holy shit, is this tiring.
Yeah.
Especially when you go and pick fights with pirate captains.
Yeah.
I mean, it was kind of cool to watch.
Energy on that.
You knocked the drunkenness out of her.
Yeah, well, literally. Again, I don't know why that would make you tired.
I think it was like secondhand sleepiness.
Okay. Let's see if everyone made it okay. It has been some time.
Oh.
Let's see. No. Yep.
Hey guys.
Oh, not yep. Married London. Yeah, that's a lot of people that made it. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Everyone. If I could have all of your attention. Welcome to, I'm not really sure what to call this place, but once upon a time, this belonged to the Alacrimatics. But now it's ours. You're going to be making use of this. All I need to understand is that you will be defecting to me, and occasionally a particular dread that's lurking around here somewhere.
Behind you.
Right there. Here. Yeah. For now... get yourselves acquainted. Go ahead and settle in their barracks upstairs. And there are various other implements. We're going to need to be able to get this place fully functional operational. So, I guess start trying to figure out where you can slot in and what you can be doing. But, we'll need to be working together. We don't really have many other options. And as for that, we're going to be trying to bring more people in here as we can. And once everything is situated and we're certain that we've got a good groundwork that we're going to stand off of, we'll let you know. For now, adjust and prepare for future advisement. Cool? Great.
Cool.
I'm so tired.
I feel...
You know what? On stream, right now, I'm going to write my little short response thing that I'm supposed to do for a class.
What?
Mood. Or yeah. I have not recruited Trivago. We'll probably do that later.
Trivago.
I never got to change the name.
Nah, recruited right. Trivago. And I never got to change the
name. I'll never have its good name. Because I never had the time to actually do it. Well, maybe I'll do it tomorrow. It just come home, it's like, hey guys, we got a new name. You're also going to war. And they're like, what?
Seven-foot oh cat, God. Rats along her cat.
Oh no, the server's backing up. Fades
to cat. Oh, no sevens in the chat.
If the server goes down, I'm not getting back on, I swear to God.
If the server goes down, you're not getting back on, too bad. I'll get a body actor and you have to voice them.
What?
Yeah, bitch. You think I'm fucking around? Probably not even gonna have
a dialogue.
Do you know who you are?
No.
Damn.
That's sad.
7 foot sad.
It's gonna be me and you'll have skinny arms. Oh no! That's so
long.
Yeah, the skinny arms.
As you can see, chat, we all want to go to bed.
Yeah.
This stream is too long because NPCs don't work.
Hours change, so think of it as like an hour later right now.
Oh shit, you're right.
Yeah.
7 foot frame.
I apologize, my dog is barking.
At least I know what I'm drawing in class for a certain version of Marshy Mallow. Yes.
Oh no.
Superior version. Oh, no. Milfy Mallow.
No.
Marshy, give us your best Ara Ara right now to fuel it.
I'm too tired to give a good one.
No, that's the exact time that you should be doing it. Oh, alright, take a deep breath, shut up, and the next thing I better hear out of your mouth is an Ara Ara.
Ara Ara.
No, it's not good.
Yeah.
Oh, what? What? Oh my god.
Yeah, I've been staring at her.
What? Oh, shit.
Hi, Iris.
Have, like a completely different voice and just like, Ara Ara.
Ara
Ara. Ara
Ara. Ara
Ara.
Ara
Ara. Hawaii Dasu.
Iris approaches you all, her hands behind her back. This is quite the impressive party you found for yourself, Rex, isn't it? Yeah, we've got a decent chunk of people. Well, I remain pessimistic on our outlook against the Edict. I understand the true power of their forces, after all. I am almost hopeful for our future against the Edict. Mm-hmm. That's not why you're here, though, is it? I don't know what you mean. Give it to me. In absolute shame, Iris would slowly bring her arms forward and would hand you a wooden cup.
What?
You snatch it from her quickly. She simply pouts. Stop bringing me these! I give up!
Wait.
Oh my fucking
my God. God.
What? Why? Why? Where are you getting them? Where are you getting them? Go sit down. No more cups.
How many cups do you even have now?
Go, leave. I'm going to sleep. You guys should too. I'm done. I'm so done.
Yeah.
Oh boy,
tomorrow
more
recruitment. I don't care which ones of you show up. It's just happening.
Yeah, I might need to go like catch up with Swan later.
Okay.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, everyone.
Probably
yeah.
Good night.